One of the I have the highest conviction over now as a scientist is the concept of grace in biology. I grew up in kind of a Christian environment, a kind of hippie church in Boulder, and great people around. And so I had kind of the lexicon of kind of a relatively open-minded church doctrine. And the word grace got thrown around in this faith community all the time. And now I'm exposed to a lot of people from all types of spiritual backgrounds, and you go into the Muslim or the Buddhist or the Jewish communities, and you hear this word grace with, you know, differing frequency, but it's out there in our lexicon. I think it can maybe both best be defined now, in my mind at least, scientifically, which is heal faster than you injure. And that's what we see in the soil, and that's what I get to see in my clinic. I see people who have abused their bodies for decades, and if they just give a pause, they do a couple of short-term fasts, they give their gut a break, they give their immune system a break, they get away from chemicals, they start growing some of their own food, they make these simple little decisions, and suddenly decades of damage is reversed in hours, weeks, months. That's grace at the cellular level, and there may be a better spiritual definition of it, but from a biology standpoint, I see grace as you're going to make mistakes, and you're going to heal faster from them when you make the change. And that's what we see in the soil. And so these farmers who are making the jump, again, we've seen 1 million acres make this transition. And so Soil Health Academy is our partners in this group, and they're four phenomenal farmers who really have been cutting the edge of this no-till, no-spray effort. And what we're seeing is that within a single growing season, you can go from this dead monoculture of corn or soybean to cover cropping with 16 different species and getting a no-till environment. You'll see the fungal elements, you'll see the mycorrhizae in there, the bacterial populations returning to the soil, and you see biodiversity returning in the form of earthworms within a single growing season of rest.
Yeah, it's the environmental planetary version of what you just explained in the human body.
It's fasting.
Right? Yeah.
Fast for just a moment. Stop doing the damage for just a short
period
of time.
The resiliency is amazing.
It's amazing. And it would have to be. There's a book recently out, and I'm going to screw up the title. I think it's something like Earth Without Humans or something like this. And it describes how fast the ecosystem is going to recover when we disappear.
We're gone.
It describes New York City 2 weeks without humans, and you see every element of the concrete infrastructure of Manhattan disappearing under biology.
Uh-huh.
And within 2 months and 2 years, and you see how fast life leaps out of this planet. And it has to be that way because it's Mother Earth.
Uh-huh.
That's how we got here. This planet's been exploding with life for millions and millions of years before Homo sapiens showed up.
But we got to combat this problem. I mean, one of the things that we talked about last time that was so shocking for me to hear was just the pervasiveness of chemical spraying. So even if you are an organic farmer, or you are a consumer buying organic, or you're trying to, you know, live in a clean environment, that glyphosate and various other chemicals are so pervasive, they found their way into our drinking water, it's in the rainwater, it's raining down onto these organic farms. So despite trying to hermetically remove ourselves from this problem, it's still, you know, something that we have to contend with, even when we're doing everything in our power to avoid it.
I mean, first of all, why is that? Why is glyphosate everywhere? It's the nature of the molecule itself. It's an amino acid backbone with a phosphate group and a carbon group on the other end. And you get this thing called an organophosphate. And organophosphates in this form are extremely water-soluble. 70% of Earth is water, and it turns out that 70% of your body is water. And so we've put into play a chemical that is water soluble that can now travel through all levels of the water ecosystem. And so in the evaporating water coming off the Mississippi River, as we collect some 80% of all of the Roundup sprayed in our country into a single water system, through the runoff that happens when we water or when the rain falls or whatever it is, we consolidate that into the Great Muddy. It shouldn't be muddy, but it's carrying all of our topsoil in it now because all of our topsoil is dead and is eroding away. An amazing estimate on that, actually. I just read that 11% of our GDP is being wasted every year in topsoil. the amount of monetary loss from our topsoil washing away is equal to 11% of GDP.
Because it's so unhealthy that it doesn't adhere?
Exactly. Yeah, there's no root structure to keep it there. There's no mycorrhizae, there's no mycelium, there's no fungal structure in the soil to keep the topsoil where it needs to be. And so every time it rains, the rain can't even penetrate the soil, which is ridiculous. It's so hard that the water, when it finally rains on your crop, can't get into the soil. Instead, it takes the top centimeter of your soil away and washes it to the nearest gully and out into the water system, which of course ends up in the Mississippi River and then into the Delta. And at the end of the Mississippi River, we now have a dead zone that's larger than the state of Rhode Island because there's so much herbicide, pesticide, and chemical fertilizer in that water. And so we've got this huge dead zone in the ocean right at the mouth of the Mississippi, and not a single politician is talking about that.
It's unbelievable.
It's dumbfounding that we can be this myopic. So soil is disappearing. All of this is broken. Yes, 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 yes. But I still want to bring it back to the simple reality is the brokenness in the system has to do with the...
Okay. We are at 3 o'clock and I think it's time to start. We just put in that filler by Zach Bush. I always, I love listening to it because it kind of almost sums up all the work which many of us have been doing in the last, personally about, 3.5 to 4 years now, but many people really on the ground who have been working. So let me first introduce myself. I'm Gauri Sareen. I'm assuming that many of us are, known to each other. I'd love to welcome many of you personally who I know very well. I hope I can see Aradhana there. I hope Vinaya is there, whom I'm going to be seeing after a long time. I'm not seeing her. I can see that she's, there she is. Yes, Vinaya is a very old friend and I've been trying to speak to her, but she's not given me any time. So something which we managed to put together and pulled her here. So, hats off. I can see Anjali here. Again, a very great friend and supporter of the movement, which we have been part of and many others out here. Till about 4 years ago, I don't think I knew anything about this space at all. There was absolutely nothing I knew about regenerative agriculture, organic food, apart from what little one heard in the social media. And I knew even lesser about nutrition, in terms of what is good. I used to always think diets are fads and never believed in them. And I don't know what happened. It was a quirk of circumstances or what propelled that to happen. But I was invited to work on an agripreneurship program with an organization. And this was a project which we were planning for women agripreneurs. And I started working with it, not realizing what I was getting into. Entrepreneurship was always very dear to me. Women, the fact that we were working for women was again dear to me. The fact that I had not done anything in the rural or agriculture sector kind of really intrigued me and propelled me to take up this project. But from there to where one is right now, I can just simply say that the space has been amazing learning for me. I've been a student, these last 4 years. And interacting with a set of people I did not even probably know they existed, apart from those little tours one did and one ran into villages. This part of the world was absolutely unknown to me as an urban Indian, as somebody who was connected to corporates. So this is this was really eye-opening for me because this set of this side of the world, one was of course people were very different from what one was used to interacting with. The systems were very different completely. But more importantly, I think this part of the world where I was connected with had one very, very close connection, which was completely forgotten. And that connection was food. Food. I don't even talk about nutrition right now, but it is food. Something which is closest to us. To our guts, to our minds, our hearts, our bodies, our, I would say even our souls. But it was completely, while it is so close to us, the connection was completely lost. And this connected me back, connected me to a very, very, very important part of our lives. And as I started getting connected, I realized that agriculture had its challenges, and the bigger challenges were that what we were eating and what was coming to us from agriculture was really, I can say safely, inedible. What was being used in terms of chemicals, pesticides, we just heard Zach Bush right now, it actually made our food close to something which would require medicine. So people say that food is medicine, and I always tell them, please don't call at least the current food medicine, because that would really not be doing justice to what food is meant to be, or what real food is meant to be. So this is where I was, and suddenly realized that what we were eating would actually lead us to medicine and not, is not really medicine. And so what would it be, what it would have to be? But the second thing which I feel, again, Zach touches on it very beautifully, is that this source of food, which today we say that food is medicine, the source of food itself had so many issues, with the soil. So chemicals and pesticides we understood, as we got along. But what was really happening to the environment? What was happening to the biodiversity? What was happening to soils? What was happening to the entire ecosystem of water? All of that, we saw that lying in front of us destroyed. So just connecting with this one little segment, and it opened a completely different world. And this is really what the world and the planet is all about. The what we were fighting for in our cities in terms of cleaner air and cleaner water and cleaner streets and all of that was a very minuscule portion of what the entire world and the ecosystem is made up of in terms of its interrelationships. So I think all of us, and the reason I'm sharing all this with you, is that really all of us who live in cities have somewhere got alienated to, where we source our food from, or even more alienated to the larger concept of what this planet really needs to be looking like, and where its resources really lie. They don't lie here in the cities where we keep fighting for our own infrastructure and amenities. So that's one. And then one got closer to food and started seeing organic and seeing people who are very passionate about it. But the more one came across a farmer who was passionate, the more one saw that this farmer didn't know how to reach out to people. And then increasingly one saw that there were things happening in the cities in large numbers, cancer, in a very big way. In my own family in the last 5 years, there are about 5 people who passed away, closest family. About 5 people would have passed away from cancer, and I realized that cancer is like a big thing. It's COVID is nothing in front of cancer. Let me say this to you, that what we are hitting upon. Then there were many other non-communicable disorders or diseases, as you might say, which were growing faster than any infection could actually grow. So there was something going on out here, and people who would grow these foods which are chemical free would say, but we don't know enough people who are interested in them. So why should we be growing them? And it's really tough for us to grow them. We don't know how to market them because the normal system doesn't seem to be creating a supply system for them. So what do we do? And from Bhumija was this entire platform of organic people. We got together to mentor them, grow them, make them more effective. We thought of the whole idea of living without medicine, that how do we really create healthy communities? People who are health conscious communities. I won't say they're healthy communities. I think people who start getting to be health conscious, and from the bottom of their heart, they really start realizing that what they are eating is so important, right? So the importance of food, the importance of every morsel they're taking, and the source of that food, where it is coming from, how it is being grown, all of that entire piece starts getting important when you start becoming conscious that your body itself is very important. Everything which you're taking in is so important. Unfortunately, most people are hit by this reality only when they end up getting a disorder. It's very few people who really understand that the importance of it till they've actually been hit by, you know, some kind of a health disaster. And so our entire attempt in creating Living Without Medicine was that it is possible for us to live without medicine. One, once you have actually got down to having an ailment or a disorder, which seems irreversible from an allopathic modern science point of view. But more importantly, if you become conscious fast enough and you see people falling in the pit and you realize that I don't want to be part of that, that big fall in the future, then you can actually prevent it, and prevent it by just doing some very simple things in your life. So we created three-way communities, and is there a presentation we can share right now? Deepak, are you on top of that? Do you have the slide? Yeah. So I just very briefly, it'll take me a couple of minutes. I don't want to take away from what you all are here for today to listen to Birendra. We can move on to the presentation. Do you have that with you? Yeah, great. So what we really started creating is what we call healthy local communities. So before, Vocal for Local came in, we had actually started talking about local communities. We had a three-pronged approach for prevention and reversal of these disorders. And this was, what is this three-pronged approach? This basically had people who were consumers. We didn't call them consumers, but members of this community, right? So community members. The second were experts who were by and large people who practiced nutrition in the way we thought it should be practiced. People who practiced Ayurveda or naturopathy, in which food is actually very central. Lifestyle and food become really central to it. So we make sure that this was the second aspect to it. And the third thing which we did is we brought in the farmers or agripreneurs who actually sell on behalf of farmers on this platform, so that people got access to the best food once they got awakened to the fact that eating the right food or real food is far more important than they have than they've realized so far. So this was a three-pronged approach which we started, and we built about 15 communities across India in tier one and tier two cities, because that's where we felt was the first level where we need to bring consciousness. I personally feel that rural areas and smaller towns have better access to real food than bigger cities actually have, because of the higher food miles involved. The second thing which we started doing is really education on these platforms. So we really had a very, very interactive space in which people would ask questions, get answered to, solve some of their issues, get educated by some of our experts. We also started organizing webinars, events, workshops, all of that. I've already spoken about the experts. And we felt this is about real natural solutions just in time. So we felt that we should be being able to solve problems just in time by giving. This is where we are heading towards. We also started introducing modern research on nutrition. And I think Birendra came in as a breath of fresh air when it came to this, because we realized that one big thing which was missing is that while we would move towards Ayurveda and some of the huge heritage, a gold mine of wisdom, which our knowledge and wisdom which exists in India and actually the world also now, we also realize there's a lot of research going on in this which needs to be known by us, so that we know what is the latest in this area. And when Birendra entered our platform, I just knew that we had hit on another gold mine here. So the main, and of course we had nutritionists who also shared about this research, but I'll share more about Birendra and we'll hold it till we finish this bit. The main focus was shifting food and lifestyle habits on our platform, giving access to growers and sellers, and create farm to fork models very naturally and organically. So we didn't force an agenda. We said, let this agenda emerge on its own. When people want good, they start demanding good food. Automatically, farmers are going to come into the cities. They're going to sell directly. And this is interestingly started happening everywhere. I will not claim that it has happened only through Living Without Medicine, but I can certainly say that we were part of this very, very big movement of getting people to eat fresh from the farms. And last but not the least, I felt our platform was really very important to go back to forgotten varieties of foods. So while there is food available and real food available, but you cannot call it real food unless and until it is diverse enough. And diversity, thanks to the monoculture of agriculture, had started getting relegated to the background. So getting these varieties back and actually realizing, creating the link between them and the fact that there are certain nutrients which all of these varieties have in nature. We don't even need to take these nutrients from anywhere else, as long as we have our entire plate full of real food, which is rich in biodiversity and which is locally available to you, which is seasonally available to you, and I always give this example everywhere, and I'm going to share this again, which is that till about 2 years ago, I did not even know that alsi was a local food of Bihar and Uttarakhand. Till 2 years ago, I did not even know that, we had over 1 lakh varieties of rice, and the only rice I would know which was worth eating was basmati. And last year, I've taken about 25 to 30 traditional varieties of rice, and each of them, so we're going to talk about a little bit about carbs, but each of them are actually far better nutrition than some of the popularly known hybrid rice varieties which we are having on our plates. So we will touch upon that a little bit. Before the session, I did tell Birendra that there are things which are not often considered the best for us, with the sedentary lifestyles we have. But nevertheless, they have some really great nutrients. So the balance is to be, really struck by us. Can we go next, Deepa? Yeah, so this is the three-way model which I was, referring to, which was grow local, buy local, eat local. We have farmers or agripreneurs, we have nutrition experts, and then we have consumers, and the whole idea is to reduce the food miles. Let's go next. And these are some of the future trends, global trends in healthy foods. I'm not going to spend too much time on this, but all that Bhumija and Living Without Medicine today is doing is really to hit upon some of these global trends, actually locally. So it's very interesting that whatever is happening in the smallest part of India is actually happening in globally in the most westernized societies. It's completely uncanny. And of course, the internet connects us beautifully to these movements. But the fact is that all these movements are almost independently and organically developing at the same time. And much more is going to happen in times to come. One of the movements I just wanted to share quickly with you that I'm supporting a lot personally is the food forest movement. Only in the last about 3 to 4 months, I personally have awakened to the fact that food forests is the future of real food, nutrient-rich food, and also biodiversity and environment. So we are really supporting it in a big way. We've created a good platform on this. We're going to go big way on this side. Let's go next. So I'm not touching the rest of it. These are some of the programs we've created earlier. We created one in March, just before we hit COVID, which was interesting because we had women speaking, two women on women's health during the International Women's Day week. We've had programs on Ayurveda, naturopathy, lots of them by some wonderful experts that we have on our platform, which we keep bringing to you again and again so that education becomes all pervasive. Next. Interestingly, we started all these programs over the last 2 years, and COVID seems to have, accelerated the whole process of getting them for us. Now we have them galore during COVID times, thanks to, online being the only means. So it's great that wellness is now picking up in a very, very big way. But I'm also glad that we started, we became part of the big trend much earlier on. So with this, I wanted to have the real privilege to introduce somebody very, very special, Birendra Singh with us. We have over 70 experts on our panel, and Birendra is actually one of our newest, expert, I would say. And so interestingly, he came, when we first spoke, he said, Gauri, I am I said, what are you? I mean, are you like a practitioner, et cetera? He says, no, nothing of the kind at all. I'm a telecom professional. And I am not in any sense a doctor or any medical practitioner with a larger stretch. So I was like a bit taken aback. I said, oh my God, you know, so who do we have here? And then he said, I call myself an accidental nutritionist. I'm taking away his words from him because he loves relating the stories, and I would leave it to him to relate this. But Birendra said he was an accidental nutritionist for a very good reason. He himself went through a very, very traumatic period, one part of which was an almost fatal accident, where almost his entire body had, you know, gone and, you know, broken and devastated and got into pieces. And how he survived it itself is a miracle. I mean, it's a living miracle. And I believe people like this sometimes will go through it, and I hope whatever be their karma, they come into our lives because they have some lessons to teach us. So I really, really feel, you know, honored that people like Birendra are there, who've gone through so much and who've come out with a fight, who've really turned it around for themselves, and who are really, you know, can inspire millions of people into doing what they had to learn the hard way, right? So, so I'm going to read a formal, introduction. Many of y'all may have already read it because I shared it extensively. He's a health enthusiast, a qualified nutrition expert. So yes, post that he did qualify. He's not a practitioner, but he has qualified himself in areas like diabetes and metabolic syndrome, and is a senior telecom professional. His workshops have guided many people in getting a deeper understanding of food and nutrition, and helped many people reverse their diabetes, high BP, cardio issues, etc. Also weight loss, and he has some very interesting things to share about weight loss, which we are eager to hear. He guides people with the right knowledge and real nutritional truths to ensure that everyone is empowered to understand their own health conditions and heal themselves instead of living with chronic diseases and consuming pills for the rest of their life. He strongly believes in let food be thy medicine, which is Hippocrates. And I always say this, that food is not your medicine. If you have the right food and real food, you don't need medicine. Birendra, over to you.
thanks, Gauriji. I hope I'm audible. And thank you very much for such a, you know, introduction. And I'm glad to be a part of a, you know, a very larger group. And you guys are working 24/7 to achieve this. I appreciate the enthusiasm of you and the entire group members, you know, managing 255 NCR 1, 2, 3. I don't know so many groups that you manage. In fact, then I suggested you a phone with a very good battery life. So for, you know, in my case, you know, it is pretty simple. You know, for me, learning was that, you know, I as Gauriji told me, that I was into, you know, a lot of medical complications post my life-threatening accident. And my learning is like this, that anybody can do it. Jab aapke piche, you know, bada sa kala kutta bhagega, to aap kya karoge? Aap bhi bhagoge, right? So when the dog is after you, you're going to be like running fast. So, you know, that's where, you know, I was able to correlate. You know, somebody said that you are a gone case. Insurance company says that, you know, boss looking at you, I cannot insure you. You are a gone case. You know, your home loan is not going to be insured. That's where it hit me hard. And really, really, you know, with the tears in my eyes, I said, no, this is not the way it has been done. So let's understand this. Who to save? Am I going to save the world? I'm going to be save my neighbor? No, nothing. I have to save myself. I have to struggle and survive in life, because I need to live, and I need to live in this world. That's where this entire, you know, learning started. And as Gauriji said, and I call it in my workshop and seminars, that, you know, accidental nutritionist, that is there. However, you know, that's something which I don't do as a part of my bread and butter. My bread and butter is a piece of telecom. Again, you know, telecom, you know, allows me to be, you know, connected with the whole world, managing the global teams while sitting in home. So let me start with the slides. Few of you would be doctors, few of you would be refreshers, few of you would be nutritionists. I promise and guarantee that there's going to be something for every one of you. And there are any questions, I'm not going to be watching the chat screen. Maybe, you know, the managers of this workshop can actually look into it. So let me start sharing the screen I've got ready. I hope, you know, that the screen is visible right now to everybody, right? Is the screen visible?
We can see you, not the screen. Deepak, can we put him on the screen on speaker's view? Right now, we can only see you, and the screen is on the side.
Is it visible?
No, we need to get you off the speaker's view, I think.
Just a minute.
You can all see the screen. I mean, is it big enough? Because I can, okay. I think the others can see it. I can only see the screen on the side. So must be something to do with me.
Yeah, okay, fine. So if that is the case, then I'm going to be starting my slides. Okay, so the word is nutrition. That's where we're going to be speaking about, but we are going to be speaking beyond this. These are almost 70 slides now. That's going to be a major one. So I'm going to be just skipping past a few of the slides quickly, and then I'm going to be stopping in between on certain slides. Yeah, so let me go to the next one. Very, very simple. You know, let's start with the basics. You know, we talk about carbohydrate, protein, and fats, right? So carbs gives you 4 calorie, protein gives you 4 calorie, and you know, fats gives you 9 calorie per gram, right? And then we are talking about the micronutrients, you know, multiple type of vitamins A, B, C, D, E, and K, and of course, you know, the minerals that we get: copper, selenium, zinc, magnesium, you know, which are termed as micronutrients. Since the kind of the audience that we have, you know, are informed or people who have you know, the interest in the knowledge of this, they should be already be knowing this. But I would like, why I put this slide, although this is very, very basic fundamentals, please go to the first three things. Carbohydrates says 4 calories, protein says 4 calories, and you know, the fat says 9 calories. And nowadays, all the experts are saying, you know, look, what? You eat fat to lose fat, right? So somebody came to me earlier, I was speaking with Gauri ji, that how a typical nutritionist came to me and said, well, you know what, Birendra, you're talking, it's a simple math. If it is 9 calorie, you know, fat is giving, then of course, you know, one should gain weight by eating fats. Then I said, Dr. Saab, have you heard about this ketogenic diet and how the ketones work? And then he started realizing the fact, but we will solve this mystery on the point number 3. In fact, I've written multiple times on fats and why the good fats are important. Let's explore this into next slide. But this is a very, very important slide. And you should remember it. And in case if you're not remember it, maybe you snap out your mobile and take a picture, because all my 70 slides are based on this. And if you learn this graph, you be a doctor yourself. I'm telling you, this is such an important slide. Now, this is basically a sugar response, which happens, you know, once we consume carbohydrate, protein, and fats. So if you look at it, when we are actually taking a carbs, how is the blood sugar is oozing up, right? And if you look at the proteins, how the, you know, the blood sugar is actually, taking a mid response. But if you look at the blue portion, okay, it's all flattened up, which means there's hardly any sugar response, which is actually happening when we are having fats. Now, this is this slide. I call this as a master slide. The entire understanding of the medical science, you know, goes behind this. And I call this as a very, very important slide. So let me go to the next. Yeah, there were questions. Gauriji had written a couple of people, you know, that are you into a metabolic syndrome, or you have any metabolic diseases? There's a lot of misunderstanding. People don't really understand what exactly is, you know, metabolic problem or metabolic issues. So somebody wrote, you know, I don't have a metabolic disease, but I have a blood pressure problem. Somebody wrote, you know, I don't have, you know, problem with the metabolic, no problem, but I'm taking a lot of, you know, type 2 diabetes medications. So the problem is, what is this? you have heart, you have this lipid problems, your cholesterol elevated, HDL, LDL, VLDL, everybody is coming and talking about, look, I'm going to be dying next day because my triglycerides are elevated. Every third or fourth person is suffering from a type 2 diabetes. Dementia is happening, right? Just like when you have a brand new car and then you are a 60,000, you have done 60,000 kilometers, your tire has worn out. Similarly, when we are aging now, people's brain are getting worn out. They have difficulty remembering their names and relatives. They're keeping silent with themselves. So we have dementia, we have Parkinson's, we have issues associated with it. Cancer, my God. The other day, I was talking, just 2 weeks before, I was talking to one young lady, 27-year-old young lady, and having a stage 4 breast cancer. You have PCOS, yeah? Young ladies are suffering a lot. We have this fatty liver, especially this non-alcoholic fatty liver. The question is, look at this gentleman with that bulging stomach. I used to be one of them at one point of time. My wife, I don't know if she's there in this workshop or not, can be, I was much more dangerous than him, the one which is visible on the left-hand side. So coming back to it, you know, the question is, do I give this to your genes and things like that? Or is it a self-inflicted wound? Where it is? You cannot leave everything to the God, gentlemen. It's the food that you are eating, the kind of the life, the kind of, you know, the diet, the lifestyle, you know, work from home is fine, but waking up at 11 o'clock, sleeping at 2 o'clock in the night, yeah. And then of course enjoying pizza and burgers. You have Domino's and you have this, you know, apps, which is going to serve you. So the problem maintains. And I call this as a self-inflicted wound. And this is a non-communicable disease. It's really not your, you know, the corona, which is actually happening right now. 70-75% of the problem is something that you could have controlled. This is with you and this is all manageable. This is non-communicable disease. It's a self-inflicted wound. Let me go to the next slide. Let's talk about the fat, you know. So when we talk about the fat, you know, there is a lot of misconception which is actually happening with the fat. You know, we know that coconut is, coconut oil is approximately 90% fat, which is there. Yeah, and coconut is, of course, it's a good fat, and we know that, it's very good for health. And now, you know, people are talking about half ketones or in a ketogenic diet and have a weight loss. But we need to understand exactly what how the fats and the carbs and the proteins are processed in your body, right? So when we, and I will also tell you what is the exact mystery of, you know, getting into this triglycerides and elevated triglycerides. You know, what is the exact reason? We'll talk about it in the later slides. So basically, I have to tell you, it's like this, that when we eat the food, a normal food, let me see if I can, tell you in this particular slide. When we eat the food, okay, what happens is when we eat the food, I mean to say the kind of the foods that we are actually having, most of the times we are using carbs or we are having a complex carbs. So what happens is the moment we consume the food, the insulin actually secretes, okay, very basics. My hand is visible. I wish I can guide. If my wife is into this workshop, can I request her to bring me a glass and a water, please? I have to explain something with a glass. I hope my video is visible here. So what I'm saying is the when you are having a carbohydrate, basically it has to convert into glucose, and glucose has to be absorbed in the cells. So what happens is the insulin is produced by your pancreas to push the glucose into the cells. Okay. So carbs, insulin, cell has to understand the insulin signaling and it has to push across, right? So if this glass is visible, right? So of course she had to fill it. So let's suppose if that's the insulin that I'm talking about, here, when we are eating the carbs, a glass full of insulin is produced. But when we are eating, let me drink this water. When we are having proteins, the count of insulin, which is actually being produced. If you understand this, gentlemen, you would reverse your diabetes problem. So that's very, very important. I'm giving you a practical demonstration now. Here, when you are eating a protein, of course, there is an insulin secretion, but obviously it's pretty less. But when you are having a fats, there's hardly any insulin secretion because the fat is absorbed in a different mechanism that absorbs in a lymphatic system. So what happens is, so here, if you look at it, the fats produce a minimum amount of insulin. The carbs had a maximum insulin and proteins had a somewhere in the middle layer, slightly less than that. We'll talk about it. Why? So, of course, here if you look at this graph, when we have a breakfast, our insulin level shoots up. And when we are in a faster state in between the breakfast and lunch, insulin level goes down. When we have a lunch, again, the insulin level goes up. And then in between lunch and dinner, it goes down. And then when we are sleeping basically and resting, the insulin level actually goes down. Now what happens is, I'm showing this glass itself. Probably this will take 300 ml. What if I put up a liter of water in this glass? What will happen? Simple, it will overflow. Similarly, what happens is the kind of the food that we are having, we are actually inducing our pancreas to produce more and more and more and more and more and more insulin, because we are eating chola bhatura, and then we have eaten rasgulla, and then we have eaten ice cream, and then we go third round, we mix ice cream and a gulab jamun all together, and then we are having such kind of things. So what will happen? Our stomach is not able to say, and we eat till our stomach says, my God, I have a gone case. या कल यार पार्टी में गए थे बहुत ज्यादा खा लिया पेट खराब हो गया. Why? So what happens is, this is, I'm just giving one particular example. Over the period of time, you keep on eating again and again and again and again. So what happens is, you are just pushing your body to produce more and more and more and more of insulin, right? Now that's the problem. And the doctor fraternity in this workshop, make a note of it. There is a slide I am going to tell you, and I'm also going to correlate with the current COVID crisis also. That why this, where is this 99.99% of the problem coming? Okay, so let's go. It's a simple slide. What I'm saying is, when we are eating, insulin level goes up, and when we are fasting, the insulin level goes down. Okay, that's what this slide I'm trying to say. Of course, now. What are we eating then, right? If you have a car and body and car, let's try to compare. So we are like, we are supposed to be organic, we have natural fuel, we have been using all this natural mist, water, seeds, nuts, whatever is written in the slide, root, fruit, vegetables, everything used to be organic, naturally grown. What we are using right now is the pesticides, sugar, biscuit, chips, Coca-Cola, sugar, alcohol, talk about it, and the external environment toxins. Now what happens if we put adulterated fuel in your car? Can you run your car at 100 kilometers an hour? No, it's going to give a problem. It's going to break down. And this is precisely happening. The younger generations are getting such serious complications. Hardly 25 years old, kidney failure, 24 years old, getting a cancer, fourth stage. I mean, we had these issues earlier, but now every third person, fourth person is becoming a diabetic person. Cardio is again, the largest number of killer. And make a note of it. All these things that I'm telling you has got a relationship. And one relationship I'm going to be telling you is going to be shocker in the last slide, which I'm going to be talking about. So let me go back. What I'm trying to say is that that's where, you know, the living without medicine and going to organic. So we need to have a right kind of fuel. We're trying to compare this with the good quality fuel that you are putting in the car. And if it is a problem, then it's a problem. So what are we eating then in that case? We are eating carbs and, you know, actually carb is just a glorified name. The carb is nothing but it's just a chemistry name of glucose. So carbs is nothing but it has to convert into glucose only, right? So what happens is, you know, when we are producing too much of insulin because of the too much of carbs, we are actually giving our body extra heavy dose of insulin. So every cell of your body has to do overwork under the guidance of the insulin signaling to ensure that it is able to push the extra glucose into the cells, right? Now what happens is the way it goes is initially what happens is when we have the food, it gets converted into glucose, and whatever the amount of glucose is supposed to go into the body cells will go. There is a leftover glucose. Now, the leftover glucose, the insulin will react with the leftover glucose and convert that into glycogen. Use the word glycogen. You can see that I have written there glycogen. But glycogen is something it's like a fast charger, just like you have in a OnePlus 70 or a latest Samsung phones or a so these are the things that our body can store the glycogen 36 hours only. So which means that let's suppose if I'm going and I'm not having a food, or I need to run, or I need to do extra physical work, and my food is not available readily with me. So the glycogen stores in our body. Glycogen is actually stored in the liver, in the muscles, in your body cells. So here what happens is the glycogen stores are being used, but maximum up to 36 hours. Beyond 36 hours, you know, we can't store. I say this is a readily available energy, the glycogen stores. And once your glycogen stores are full, make a note of it. People who are fat, people who are obese, listen this carefully. Okay. So what happens is beyond your glycogen stores are full, you still have a glucose in your body. Because you have every day you are eating. So what happens? Insulin reacts with the leftover glucose and converts that into fat. So eat food, increase insulin, and then of course you are storing the fat in the different areas of the body. So this is the mystery that you need to understand, and the insulin, over secretion of the insulin with the kind of the food that you are doing. So that's what this is all textual forms which I have written. Yeah. And where all it is going, liver, kidney, brain, heart, everything is made of cells itself, right? So we are creating a problem with the overconsumption of the food. We'll go back to it. Of course, one of the things which comes is the diabetic. I'll come to it. Because see, what happens is, what is a diabetic? People who are diabetic in this group, please understand this very, very carefully. I'm going to be telling you the secret here. The secret here is that diabetic, what we say is an increased blood sugar, and we are treating a blood sugar. Blood sugar is just a symptom. It's only a symptom. It's not the real problem. What is the real problem? The real problem is that every organ, whether eye, liver, kidney, right, heart, and body muscles, everything is made of cells. Cells needs energy in the form of glucose. Insulin comes, tells the cell to absorb glucose. Cells does the job. When you are over secreting insulin because of the virtue of eating food, you are surrounding your cells with a lot of insulin. So what will happen is the receptors, the insulin receptors of your cells, they get damaged. जैसे if I tell in Hindi कि अगर आपको बहुत ज्यादा अगर ठंड लगती है तो आप क्या करोगे, आप स्वेटर पहन लोगे, और आप ले लद्दाख गए then you have to wear two sweaters or three sweaters just to control because of the environment which is hostile. Here what will happen is with the too much of the insulin which got secreted by the kind of the food that you have been eating, or the junk food or the carbs or you know other stuff which resulted in a too much of insulin secretion, your body goes beyond a threshold value and your cells become insulin resistant. So once the cells become insulin resistant, you are still eating, the glucose will come, but now insulin will also come. Your body cells will say, who the hell are you? I don't know you. So your body cell would not understand the instructions of insulin. So it will not open to absorb glucose inside it. Now that's a problem. So which means you had the food, you had the glucose, but it was not able to get into inside your cell. Why? Because your cell has become insulin resistant. It doesn't understand what was the job of insulin. And then when I say cell, which means every part of your body, whether eyes or brain or liver or kidney, or you have neuropathy, lot of things, every area. Just imagine agar pauda hai, green pauda hai, agar usme aap pani hi nahi daloge to pura ka pura ped pehle sook jayega aur collapse ho jayega. This is what exactly is happening. And today in the medical science, today what we are doing right now is just killing the symptom of elevated glucose. What is the healing mechanism is to correct the defective insulin signaling. We are having metformin there. We are trying to ensure that extra insulin secretion happens. We are trying to show off extra insulin using insulin dosage, extra insulin dosage. So there are lot of variation and different combination. The question is, if that was the question of healing, why the hell in this world you are eating a diabetic medicine for 25 years of your life, and yet you are getting a kidney failure, you are getting a cardio failure? Why? That's a problem. Similarly, here, look at this starch. Wow, what is starch? Aloo khaya starch hai, chawal hai wo starch hai, bread hai wo starch hai, rice. Question is, what is this? Simple, man. Starch is nothing. It's just a chemistry. What is reality? It's just a glucose which you are taking in. And then there's another problem. Wow, you know, this marketing people are smart people. So then, wow, this is a white bread. So let me fool the people, and then they have this whole grain bread with extra fiber and etc. etc. Yeah, does it make a difference? Doesn't make a difference. So what I'm showing this with the slide is that we are actually having the kind of the food, you know, whether we are in the diabetic condition or whether we are not, please make a note that this is nothing to do with diabetes. Okay, I'm telling you where the hell lot of issues you are going to get in the later part of the life and why you're going to get. So here this is a very very simple slide which says that no, look, this is a starch and this is going to be getting converted into sugar inside your body. Go to the next slide. Yeah, my favorite topic. After listening to me, many people stop eating wheat. Now, there's a problem. Now, if you look at this particular slide, yeah, look at the kind of glycemic index of wheat. It's nearly 70 plus. It's more than banana. So basically it contains a amylopectin A. Now that's really there are different categories of amylopectin A, B and C. Yeah, and wheat being an amylopectin A, type, it's highly digestible. It's more digestible than your bananas and potatoes, gentlemen. And of course, amylopectin C is the least digestible. So what happens is the moment you are having a wheat, okay? Of course, you know, we have a nice chapati, we feel like eating more and more and more that, you know, or a aloo paratha type of thing. But what I'm trying to say is that this is where it's getting efficiently converted into sugar. Look at the index. The key word that you should note it down is this amylopectin A, and you can Google it out also. That's where I want to explain you. So what happens then? You know, when I was like 3 year or 4 year old, my mom gave me a chapati. When I was in 5 year old, I have a chapati. When I was 10 year old, I had a chapati. Abhi umar 50 saal ki ho gaye, tabhi roti kha rahe. Wo 3 saal se khana shuru kiya tha. Daily khate hain. जाड़े में खाते हैं, बरसात में खाते हैं, पंजाब में खाते हैं, साउथ में चावल खाते हैं, मगर खाते जरूर हैं क्योंकि हमारे पूर्वजों ने सिखा दिया. बट देन देयर इज अ डिफरेंस ऑफ व्हाट वीट यूज्ड टू बी अर्लियर एंड व्हाट वीट इज करेंटली. सो व्हाट हैपेंस देन? नाउ प्लीज डोंट लुक इनटू योर स्टमक. आई नो 70% ऑफ यू माइट बी सफरिंग लाइक दिस. There's a book also which is very popular, and most of you might have read that book, Wheat Belly. Otherwise, it's there in Amazon, and you can search it out on the Google, etc., etc., and you can buy that book and read. Well, that's where the problem is. The modern milling process, all the fibers of the wheat taken out, and you have this amylopectin A. And then, of course, you have the gluten content in the wheat, what our forefathers used to had, and today's wheat is almost 40 to 60% higher. Now, gluten doesn't mean that people with a gluten sensitivity or a celiac problem. Please don't misunderstand. This is, I repeat, quote and under quote, is going to happen to everybody. I'll tell you why. At a later stage. Of course, these are things that, I've shown you that obviously diabetes and heart disease, cancer, liver, dementia, amputation, and vision loss. Now, why people say that obesity is something else, diabetes is something else, coronary heart disease, cancer, because somebody in my family had a cancer, so I will get a cancer. Somebody, my mom had a breast cancer, so I'll get a breast cancer. Somebody, my father died of a heart attack, so it's necessary. Please, 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 don't leave everything to your genes. Of course, genes play a role, but 99% is the kind of the food, the kind of environment that you live. They trigger your genes. Otherwise, whatever the issues, they keep lying there in a dormant stage. It's only you which is responsible for it. Now here, if you see, this is everybody, every alternate person is having this problem, right? So the problem is what exactly is happening? Let's go into it. Okay. Now, another problem. Now, when I start writing, I write a couple of them in the WhatsApp group also. That says that it's fine, theek hai, chawal kabhi khayenge, that way I can vary it and stuff like that. But fruits is best. So I can have as many as mango I want. I can have as many as pineapple I want. I can have fruit in the afternoon, food in the breakfast, food in the lunch. Somebody says, Guruji कहते हैं कि शाम को सूर्यास्त के बाद फ्रूट नहीं खाना चाहिए. चलो भाई शाम को नहीं खाते फ्रूट, दिन में तो दबा के खाएंगे. वो अगर लखनऊ में रहते हैं तो 4-5 तो दशहरी आम तो हम खा ही लेंगे. भाई हमारा लोकल है, ईट लोकल, थिंक लोकल, ईट लोकल. तो 5-6 आम खा लो एंड देन हैव दिस नाशपाती एंड ऑल दिस बनाना. ओ माई गॉड, आई कैन फीस्ट ऑन बनानास. फाइन, यू कैन हैव इट, बट देन मॉडरेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड. नाउ बट द प्रॉब्लम हियर इज that there is again a misguidance here. Why? Very, very simple. When we are having a carbs, of course, we are producing a glucose in the body, and eating fruits produce fructose. And where is the fructose absorbed? Right now, we are not in a two-way interactive medium. But I saw some Bengali doctor in some YouTube who claims to be reversing diabetes in 24 to 48 hours, maybe. Whether you give him type 1 diabetes or type 2 diabetes, he will just make a person walk on the stage. And then he will say, look, you know, I'm giving him a banana. Make him eat banana, make him eat fruit. And after 2 hours, you know, I will check his blood sugar and there'll be, look, there is no blood sugar at all. See, the glucometer would not, rise up. He's absolutely, uska blood sugar nahi hai. Khub kele daba ke khao. Such a slang, people. I'm telling you why. Because what happens is fructose is basically metabolized in your liver, okay? It doesn't get metabolized in your normal body cells. To get metabolized in the normal body cells, you require an insulin signaling. But in a case of a fruit, which is a fructose, which is absorbed in the liver, it doesn't require insulin signaling at all. So since it doesn't require insulin signaling at all, the blood sugar would not rise up. As simple as that. Right? So after eating banana, your blood sugar is not rising. Or after eating fruit, your blood sugar is not rising. That means you should eat banana in the morning, afternoon, and evening. If you are a diabetic, or even if you are not a diabetic, a normal person. No. I'll tell you why. I mean, banana has its own benefit. Everything is moderation. What I'm trying to say is overabundance and overeating of the sugary foods. I'll tell you why this happens. This is another important slide, gentlemen. If you are into a medical field, you can take a snapshot of it. And if you are a normal audience, you can take a snapshot of it. Ye pura factory hai, factory. Kis cheez ka factory hai? Fat banane ka. Wo jo fat hai na, aapke hip pe hai, peeche, baho mein hai, chehre pe fat layer baitha hua hai. Right? Wo 20 saal se motapa nahi ja raha hai. Are bhai, ye aapki factory hai. To ye aapki factory ki body jo banata hai. This is where I'm going to be telling you now. What happens exactly here is, that when we are eating of fruit, right, or we are having a consumption of starches, sugar, yeah. So what happens is here, the fat creation which actually happens, is happening directly from the liver. So why? Because when you are having lot of fruit, even the normal fruit has food has got a fructose component. So what happens here is that your liver starts producing the fat. So it becomes a fat churning machine. So carbohydrates, insulin, and fatty acids, it's all synthesized getting in the liver. So there is a process which is induced in the liver. We call this as a de novo lipogenesis, right? So is the screen visible?
Now you are visible and the screen has gone.
Okay, 1 minute, please. Is it visible?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is a de novo lipogenesis process which happens. So what happens is here, the fat creation directly happens from the machine itself, which is your liver. So this becomes one point of fat creation. Okay, and it keeps on ramping up and keep on producing the fats. Now, is there any limitation for this? How much fat it can create? There is no theoretical limitation. You can be 100 kgs, you can be 200 kgs, you can be 300 kgs. I'm sure you should have come across a 500 kg person in somewhere in the YouTube or some news channels. So the question here is that all these things are happening. Now, you might have heard, daru mat pi. दारू पीने से लीवर खराब हो जाता है. नो, व्हाट इज दारू? दारू इज नथिंग, इज मेड ऑफ ऑरेंजेस एंड वेरियस अदर दिस व्हाट वी कॉल इन हिंदी अंगूर, यू नो, ग्रेप्स एंड ऑल. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज हियर अगेन, दैट्स अ फ्रुक्टोज. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज, वेयर इज द फ्रुक्टोज गेटिंग मेटाबोलाइज्ड? इट्स देयर इन द लीवर इटसेल्फ. वेयर इज अल्कोहल मेटाबोलाइज्ड? कोर्स इन द लीवर. व्हाई? कोर्स fructose element. So what happens is, when you are pushing up and shoving up too much of fructose in your liver, it liver starts churning fat. De novo lipogenesis. De novo means new. Lipogenesis is the fat creation process. So the DNL happens. This is your fat creation machine. Here it happens. And then, bang. You know, first of all, the fat gets accumulated at the place where the fat was created itself, which is the liver itself. And beyond this, then it, via the bloodstreams, it gets circulated to the rest of the areas of the body. So here, that's what I'm trying to depict here. Let me just put this in a PowerPoint presentation mode. One minute, please.
Yeah, I think we need to go bigger on the screen. Yeah.
Is this better?
Yeah, this is fine.
Yeah. So I'll come back to it. So this is basically what I'm trying to understand, make a note of it, is the DNL process itself. And there is no theoretical limit as to amount of the fat, which is, and if you understand this, you should be able to understand the fatty liver. You know, most of the guys are, or the females are into the, and fat and liver is very, very important when it comes to the hormone and various other hormone signals. It's the biggest, one of the biggest organs in the body. But today, the kind of the food that we have, foods, every alternate person is suffering from a fatty liver.
So I think we need to hear probably explain the difference between having high carbs leading to fat versus good fat.
Yeah, we'll come to it at a later on slides. Yeah, but here, just understand this, that I'm just showing you a fat creation machine itself through a process which is known as de novo lipogenesis. Okay, you are inducing this DNL process with the kind of the food that you are actually having. Unfortunately, the kind of the fats when you have, okay, the fats which you have, the fats are actually getting absorbed in the lymphatic system itself. So the fat creation doesn't happen because the main gist of creating the fat is through insulin signaling. Insulin signaling doesn't happen at all. Remember the very first slide where I told there's hardly any insulin secretion which happens when you consume a fat. So here, what happens is that, you know, the kind of the food which is actually we are having, so and the kind of stuff, whether we are having a fructose or sucrose. And why I'm saying fructose here a bit, because people think that you can have n number of sugary fruits and you can get away with it. I say that having a sugary fruits, make a note of it, too much of the sugary fruits is again more dangerous than having a actual sugar in your mouth. I hope everybody understands this, right? Hindi mein we say it as a bhutta. We call it as a high fructose. So here in US, etc., there is a lot of production of the corn happens. So these smart guys, 40, 50 years before, they learned how to create a sweetening agent out of it. So we called it as a high fructose corn syrup. They made a syrup out of it. And they saw that they can put this, and very, very cheap. Okay, it's even cheaper than sugar. So what happens is, once they are giving this, they can have the products made of this HFCF. When they are putting this inside, they can have this in a longer shelf life. So they can have put this in a pizza. We have bread. You have this in a Britannia cake, ketchup, all those things that you find in the big bazaar. Okay, they don't want that to rot. So what they are doing, they are putting this high fructose corn syrup here, the sweetening agent, those Britannia cake which is there. If they put good inside that, if they put sugar, that's costly. Aur wo 4 din mein kharab ho jayega. High fructose corn syrup denge, kharab hi nahi hoga. Increases the shelf life. The Coca-Cola that you have, or the thumbs up that you have, or a Fanta you have, whatever those cold drinks that you have, all of them are containing, the sweetening agent is high fructose corn syrup itself. Now, that's an important slide. You know, we need to understand. We keep on having high proteins. Too much of protein. We have carbohydrate levels. We are into a lot of tension. We increase our cortisol levels. We are again putting a lot of stress by having too much of a fructose. Fructose itself is not bad, but what I'm saying is too much of the fructose. So what happens? What is the outcome of it? Of course, we are having obesity, high triglycerides, low HDL, we are into hypertension, we are into diabetes, we are into fatty liver. I'll talk about the cancer also in the next slide, so I'll skip it fast. Yeah, so now now we say that fasting is good, fasting is this, a lot of foreign writers are writing books and all. Hey, come on, in Hindus, in our ancient Ayurveda system, fasting has been practiced since ages, right? And fasting is practiced in all religions across the world, right? So what happens is, when we are feeding, we are eating food, increasing insulin, and extra food is getting stored in our body. Of course, liver is doing the job and it's producing the fat. It goes to different areas of the body. Some bit of fat is again left over in the liver itself. And when we are fasting, what happens? The insulin level goes down. Remember earlier slide? And of course, we are able to burn the stored fat in our body once we are not eating, basically, because insulin level goes down. Body has to have a basic level of functionality. So it basically produces a hormone which is known as glucagon, G-L-U-C-O-G-E-N. I had written a cat and a mouse story earlier in the WhatsApp group. So what does a glucagon does? Once you are not having the food, your body has to work, your heart has to work, your blood has to circulate, your kidney has to work. So what happens is, we have another hormone secretion happens in the body, which is known as glucagon. So what a glucagon will do is it will actually work on your stored fat and produce energy out of it so that your basic metabolism function can be stored. It's just like a battery bank that you have, when you are going outside, you carry an extra battery bank, right? So it's like 10,000 mAh or 20,000 mAh. So I call people with extra fat. Somebody is like 10,000 mAh, somebody is like 20,000 mAh, 30,000 mAh. The basic body structure remains the same. When we used to live in caves, what used to happen? We will hunt the animals, we'll eat it. We are not sure that we'll be able to catch the prey next day or day after tomorrow. So the extra energy would be stored in the fat, as in the form of the fat. Fat is not bad, make a note of it. So that in case if you're not getting able to kill the animal or you're not able to have food tomorrow, your stored fat will be acting as a food for you. Remember in Antarctica or various other cold places, the polar bear, right? Such a fatty fellow. Once he is able to have his food during the extreme winters, he doesn't have to go and hunt outside, right? What? His stored fat will be used as energy for him. Now today, is our body structure different than what used to be millions of years of before when we used to live in cage? No, it's all the same. There's hardly any difference. There's hardly any difference. We are the same fellow who used to live in the caves and used to hunt for the animals. But now there's a difference. Every half a kilometer you have a Pizza Hut, you have Domino's Pizza, you have this Moti Mahal and all these eating joints. So the problem is not the food. The problem is over food and the quality of the food. Yeah. So what happens? We are actually tinkering with everything. With obesity goes up, hormone imbalances, you have a fatty liver. So you have issues after issues and after issues. Look at this fellow. Yeah. One thing, this is important. Please listen carefully. मैं उन लोगों के लिए बता रहा हूं सीक्रेट जिनका वजन नहीं कम होता है. एंड दिस इज द ट्रूथ आई एम टेलिंग यू. ओके, लेट मी वंस आई टोल्ड टू गौरी जी, आई स्टे हियर इन ग्रेटर नोएडा एंड हमारे यहाँ वी हैव अ टॉप ऑफ द लाइन सोसाइटी एयर कंडीशन जिम. लेडीज आती हैं, जेंट्स भी आते हैं, स्पेशली लेडीज आई विल टेल. वो जिम करती है बेचारा डेढ़ घंटे तक, उसके बाद 11 बजे उनके जब हस्बैंड्स ऑफिस चले जाते हैं तो दे हैव दिस जुम्बा क्लासेस, जुम्बा क्लासेस हो जाता है. उस जुम्बा क्लासेस को करने के बाद फिर जो है एक किटी पार्टी होती है, उसमें फिर वो सब छोले भटूरे, समोसे, बेस्ट ऑफ द डेलिकेसीज खाते हैं. वीक में दो बार किटी पार्टी हो जाती है. इंस्ट्रक्टर को हायर करते हैं 6 to 8,000 काइंड ऑफ पर मंथ यहाँ पे. और उसके बाद फिर एक महीने बाद उस इंस्ट्रक्टर की क्लासेस लगाती हैं कि मैंने तुमको 6,000 रुपया महीना दिया जुम्बा डांस की ट्रेनिंग के लिए तुमने बोला था कि मेरा वेट कम हो जाएगा, मेरा वेट तो 100 ग्राम नहीं कम हुआ, मेरा तो पैसा तुमको बर्बाद कर दिया ना। पुअर इंस्ट्रक्टर ही डज लाइक दिस, ही डजंट हैव अ आंसर। द प्रॉब्लम इज दैट यू आर ऑलवेज ईटिंग, सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज योर इंसुलिन लेवल गेट्स ऑलवेज रिमेन एलिवेटेड। द मोमेंट योर इंसुलिन लेवल गेट्स एलिवेटेड, ओके, your fat will never burn. And if the insulin level is lower, doctors, please make a note of it. This is again an important slide because I'm going to be correlating this even with corona at a later stage. I'll brush through my slide. I'm going to be relating this with corona, and you will find why I'm going to be relating this with corona. This is not me. This is the research papers that, which I have circulated in the group. If somebody wants those research papers, I would also send across. So of course, you see the difference between left and right. This fellow was able to control his insulin levels. That's why he's remaining fit. And this fellow is overeating, not able to control over exuberations of insulin. He always remains fat. No matter what he'll do, you will never lose weight. I'll skip over this slide. So what happens now? We are in a vicious cycle. We are insulin resistant. Slowly, more insulin resistance, body will produce extra insulin to overcome the insulin resistance. So we get into a vicious cycle where insulin resistance itself is creating more and more insulin resistance. It's a 360 degree approach. Ek gol chakkar mein badh jate hain. See, the body cells need energy. Very, very simple. Body cells need energy. You are eating food. Fine, food gets in, it has to go into the cell, cell has to await the insulin instructions. Now, since it is insulin resistance, food is not getting in, your pancreas will produce more and more and more and more insulin. If it is producing more and more insulin, what will happen? The objective is to put the glucose inside the cell, but your cell is becoming resistant. So it is shoving up extra insulin, which in turn is again creating more and more and more and more insulin resistance problem. Now to all of you, please make a note of it here henceforth. What I'm trying to say is we are getting into a kind of 360 degree approach where you have a lot of problems getting created in your body with the extra insulin secretion, which has happened. We'll go to it. I'll skip over the slides. Oh yeah, I'm a diabetic or a blood sugar or I'm a mota hoon. Agar diabetes nahi hai to kya? Ye jo main sweetener kha leta hoon, sugar free and all this kind of things. Don't do, my dear. I beg of you, please don't ever consume all this sugar frees of the world because this is a neurotoxic. Basically, it is sugar free for you, but the kind of the chemicals it has. You will end up actually, your body doesn't know that you are taking a sugar or you're taking a sugar free. So what will happen? More and more problems is going to happen. So don't even think for this. People will ask if I am not, sugar is so good, of course it simulates your dopamine receptors. So what has to be done then in that case? What is a safer option? Well, you can have stevia. Stevia is a safer option. You can have better not to have any sugar, but if you are not able to control your tongue and your emotions and your happiness and you still want a sugar is such a thing, dusron ko aaj lecture de rahe hain, main khud fridge mein se chura ke laddu khata tha, or I got a chocolate for my son a couple of years. I do it. I'll just steal the chocolate and half of his chocolate I'll eat him because sugar feels so good. Of course, I'm not into any metabolic issues. Once in a time, you can always do that. But of course, the control is the bigger word here. So what I'm trying to convey to the slide, don't go for this artificial sweeteners. Look at this companies, which is visible. You can take a screenshot of this. They all are sponsored. Kellogg's, Mars, Novo Nordisk, Pepsi. They all sponsors of, academic journals. Doctors, please understand, the truth better than me. they all sponsors papers. You talk about headline, you talk about this, you talk about doctors, MD, all sponsored paper. We know the truth. Who wants the truth would not come to you? These companies. Because you are the product for them. You don't consume their medicines. If you cure your diabetes, or if you cure your cardio, who the hell in this world will be able to perform the surgery too? So that's a problem. Yeah, of course. Very, very interesting. Having said that, no, this is a go to any mall, and this is all, of course, you know, they are such good. Look at this picture, you know, dekhne pe kitna acha lag raha hai. Especially this blue, what to say, this some sort of ice cream which is there. Or
Birindraji?
Yeah.
Birindraji, we are really running short of time. I know you have lots of things to cover.
I'll put it slightly fast. So here, what will happen is, I'll not go to the typical glycemic index and all this thing. That's a fad which is not really correct. Cancer is actually happening. I would like to tell you that I'm dealing with a lot of cancer patients to the extent that my mom has been a breast cancer patient herself. Of course, we never went for the chemotherapy or any kind of radiotherapy and all, and it is all fixed, and with the God's grace, she is hale and hearty. So what happens, what I'm trying to convey to in this cancer slide here is that they love sugar. Okay, see what happens is every part of our body has got a power plant in itself. We call this as a mitochondria. So what happens is these are the powerhouse of your the cells which is there in the body. Cancer cells have a weak mitochondria. So what happens is they're always look out for the energy so that they can grow and they can multiply. So what happens is when we are actually having a sugar means any form, whether we are taking a sugary fruit or we are taking sugar in the terms of carbs or we are taking in the terms of starches, they actually absorb 50 to 16 times more glucose and they grow faster. And of course, so the question here is that we are into a problem. One hand you are getting a chemotherapy, and then we are eating a paratha or a aloo paratha or a roti or a bread or a multiple mangoes, multiple bananas. Will you survive? No, you have actually screwed up your the immune system by getting into a chemotherapy, and then you are feeding your cancer cells with a lot of sugar. So the question is here, what you need to control is, you have to control the way that you are taking a food. You need to get into something which is known as, make a note of it. This is a guidance for all of you who has got a tumor or who has got a cancer, whatever stage, I don't care, is that you need, and you have a power to starve those cancer cells. Very, very important. How do I starve those cancer cells? You get your body into a nutritional ketosis. Make a note of it. Our body cells, this, please look into my hand now. Our body cells can feed on fat as well as feed on sugar, which is glucose. So they can consume glucose or they can consume the ketones, which is produced after metabolism of the fat. Cancer cells, they cannot, apart from glucose, they cannot consume fat. They cannot consume ketones. Body cells, ketones as well as glucose, cancer cells only glucose. So how do I starve my cancer cells? You cut off the glucose supply line to them. That's it. That's it. And you would see that the cancer cells will start degrading and with a virtual file out. Just by correcting the food component, we call the line of treatment as a nutritional ketosis, where we starve the people with the glucose. And of course, 99% of you will still say glucose is important. Yes, it is there. But can I live my life without glucose? Yes, if you are in a medical condition, nothing is happening. You can just change your lifestyle. You can change your diet. Let your cancer die out. Starve your cancer with depriving this from the glucose. That's it. And red meat, trans fat, I'm not going to be talking all this GMOs and, food has to be fresh. And then, of course, these are things that, going to have when you are going to have a cancer. fresh broccoli and all these green vegetables, garlic, onion. All of us are aware of it, so I'll rather zoom past it. Of course, we need to have omega-3s of the world. We have written enough in the groups, and we have said enough that omega has got multiple benefits, and omega-3 is a good fat which is not being produced in our body. So we need to ensure that omega-3 comes from outside. We can take a fatty fish, or we can take chia seeds, flax seeds, blah blah blah. So I'm not going to be talking much more on this. So broccoli, carrots, beans, berries, cinnamon nuts, olive oil, turmeric, citrus fruit, flax seeds, garlic, all these things are there. Maybe if the slides are there, you can just go through it, or maybe Goriji might share the recording. So I'll just go past it. But what I'm trying to convey to here in this one particular slide is you have to understand it's your glucose which is feeding the cancer cells. Inflammation, that's another problem, right? So inflammation is something, where our immune system is, start acting against ourselves. There are multiple markers, there are multiple ways and means where the inflammation can happen, and of course, the kind of the food, the environmental toxins that we are exposed to it. So where the role of the immune system was basically to take care of ourselves in terms of any issues or any pathogen attack, immune system gets misguided and starts attacking ourselves itself, So it is. It can lead into multiple issues. Even your cancer, Alzheimer's. Then we have rheumatoid arthritis and multiple. Especially, it will also help in the all the autoimmune diseases, which is actually people are suffering. So let's understand this. What are we getting the inflammatory foods from? Fructose that we are using, the kind of the snacks that we're using. We are having trans fats, vegetable and seed oils, dangerous man, refined carbohydrates, excess alcohol, meats, omega-6 that we are in. Omega-6 and omega-3 ratio has to be like 1:4, where 1 unit of omega-3 and has to be 4 units of omega-6. But what the ratio is going as one, all those fried foods or oily foods or, fried items, we have this trans fats and all. What is doing? Your body was, please understand, your body was not meant for eating a fried food or a fried samosa. Come on, your ancestors living in the craze were not knowing how to cook. They used to eat fresh, they used to eat raw, they used to eat natural. They were not using those OTG grillers and stuff, different kind of machines that you use in the kitchen. My wife should be knowing much better than me. So what I'm trying to convey here is that we have a skewed ratio, and all of them are actually leading into the inflammation in the body. And make a note of it, all the females in this group, please understand a very, very basic fact that you and difference between the male and the female is X and a Y chromosome and double X chromosome. You have a double X chromosome. We'll talk about it. I have written articles at a later stage, not in this particular workshop. But of course, it is a double-edged sword. So you are more keen, or you are more likely to have autoimmune diseases. So that's why we have this lot of autoimmunity problems, mostly in females. Especially, we are getting a lot of rheumatoid arthritis cases and all. So stop eating all those junk foods and all. Have fresh, organic, green, blah, blah, blah. Arthritis is happening in the joints, right? Stiffness. Ghutna chala gaya hai. Issues are happening. Come on. Who is responsible? Of course, you are responsible for it. Then how do I change? Okay. Balance your omega-3, omega-6, have walnuts, fish oil, fatty fish, fresh. Vitamin D is very, make a note of it. Vitamin D, man. This is the largest. I think I've written most of, in our group also, we have written most articles on vitamin D. This is underestimated. Ensure enough of vitamin D, and you are not vitamin D deficient. So these are grapes, chia seeds, flax seeds. So these are all fresh fruits, organic, close to nature, nothing artificial. As a rule of thumb, your food has to be made by nature, not made by man in the factories. Rule of thumb, eat food done by the God. Don't eat processed food in the factories, right? So that's the rule. Now here,
can we touch a little bit of more about how inflammation happens? Beyond what you've already shared.
Yeah, so basically what happens is here, I'll tell you one simple example. Guys, please understand, it's good that Goriji is asking me this question. Okay, here's very, very, let me tell you an example how the inflammation is actually happening. Now, again, I'll since this glass is there to me, consider this glass as your intestine. Okay, here, the food goes like this. This is the intestine. So what happens is, you know, we're talking about the small intestine or large intestine. So what happens is, you know, when we are having the, let me give an example, a very, very simple example of gluten. Please note of it, don't be misguided by somebody saying ki gluten unhi logo problem hota hai, 1% jo America mein celiac sensitive. No man, you are just misguided. I'm telling you what exactly has happened. Gluten is a binding protein inside the wheat. So when you are having too much of the wheat on a daily basis, the gluten is not easily digestible. We are really not, our body is not designed to handle the gluten. So what happens is, when we are having a gluten, the inside the walls of our intestines or the gut, we call it inside this, the gluten tears onto it. Isko kehte na chhil deta hai. Every time you are actually having this large amount of gluten or a persistent amount of gluten, what happens is a portion, this tears into your intestine walls. Make a note of it, the cells of your intestine, they are the fastest growing cells. So every 5 to 7 days, your cells inside the intestine, they are able to regrow. Your gut cells, they are able to regrow. But what happens is every day you are tearing with the kind of the foods that you are eating. So what happens is here, the gluten, basically, since it's tearing onto your cells, it leaks outside the gut area.
Or leaky gut.
Intestine, okay? We call it as leaky gut. You got it, Goriji, correct. So once it leaks, it comes into the bloodstream, your immune system says, who the hell is this? I don't know. Who is this gentleman? This should be a pathogen. Let me kill him. Okay. So your immune response goes and starts working it out and try to kill that. The next day you had an aloo paratha in some famous eating joint in Lucknow or I don't know, Delhi or some Punjabi dhaba somewhere. You know, aapne char parathe daba ke khaye. Andar se kya hua? Wo gaya idhar se intestine mein aur gaya gluten. वहां से निकला और वो फिर नेक्स्ट डे आल्सो योर इम्यून सिस्टम इज फाइटिंग द सेम अमाउंट ऑफ यू नो पोर्शन ऑफ इट ग्लूटेन हियर. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज नाउ इम्यून सिस्टम इज जस्ट यू आर पुटिंग टू मच समवेयर इट इज लीकिंग अक्रॉस योर इम्यून सिस्टम इज ट्राइंग टू रिमूव दिस एज अ पैथोजन. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज इट स्टार्ट्स माउंटिंग अ स्लो 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 सो इट इज आग लगती जा रही धीरे 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 and that's where your immune system is completely basket and then you get into a strong autoimmune response. Okay, and this autoimmunity is actually happening in the signals cascade. Now we have IL-6, IL-23, IL-16, IL-23, then INF-alpha. These are all complex part of the immune system. We are not going to go into a deep discussion. This is going to be out of the scope. So it's as simple as things, simple as gluten is the one which caused the immune response. The problem in the today's medical world is no people tell you how to eat medicine. Aapko rheumatoid arthritis hai, aapko ghutne mein problem hai, aap le rahe ho, uske baad doctor bola aap dawai kha lo, aap painkiller kha lo, but you are not addressing the root cause. Why are you misguiding your immune system? Now that's the problem. So this is just a simple example of I gave it to you.
So is just quick one here again is that here I see the gut health as very, very key to keep inflammation in check, as well as and also alkalinity. Now we were talking about alkalinity today.
I will cover gut and I'll have to skip very fast, guys, because I'm running out of the time. We had a time at till 4:30.
So we had so Birendraji, just a request to you. I think people are saying they're willing to wait another 15-20 minutes. They're happy.
Yeah, that is the problem. Whenever I take workshop, people don't go. That's a problem. And then people ask to stretch. but then I will be faster. You just keep on watching the photo. And Goriji, if you feel that there's something that, because I'm not looking at the chat window, you might be looking into it. So you can stop me in the between, okay? So this is a simple, not a big deal, not a rocket science. This is where you have the plague deposition being done here. Who is responsible? Not your grandfather who had a cardio disease. ये बाप दादा का नाम लेके बचना ये बहुत तगड़ा lame excuse है. Somebody comes to me कि मेरे दादा को हार्ट अटैक था. अरे भाई आप तो छोले भटूरे खा रहे थे ना, दादा ने क्या कर दिया आपके, आप खा के बैठे हो. So what I'm trying to say is don't blame your genes. Genes gets activated on the kind of things that you are giving, by the kind of the food that you are giving. Atherosclerosis problem, right? Now what happens again, this atherosclerosis process which is happening, ye yahan pe plaque build up ho raha hai, arteries mein break ho raha hai, coronary artery disease ho rahi hai, ye sawal hai ki bana kaun raha hai, who is creating this? You. How? The kind of the food that you are having basically is ensuring that you are secreting too much of insulin. Reacts with the glucose, converts that into fat. More insulin, more glucose, more fat. More glucose, more insulin, more fat. Fat, 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 fat. Different areas of the body. Now, fat bhi do tarike ke hote hain. One is subcutaneous, which is below the skin, and one is visceral fat, which is deposited. Two type of fat: subcutaneous within the skin and visceral, which is there inside the organs, in your pancreas, in your kidney. Not in kidney, in your liver, in your muscles, and various other parts of the body. So what I'm saying is that we have a process which is like remember I showed you a cycle. So we get into this and we have a plaque formation and we have this fatty deposition process which begins. We call it as atherosclerosis. So atherosclerosis begin and we have this all the arteries starts getting choked. So look at the different stages. Earlier it was, look at the top of the diagram, it was clear. Then you have the small plaques, this plaque and that plaque. Okay, what we do if I don't know if there is a cardiologist in this group or not, I don't know, but even if there is a cardiologist, sorry sir, today I'm using the word 99% of the cardiology is surgeries are being done after inducing the fear in you. Aapne ye dekha hoga na ki 100 kilo ka aadmi 70 kilo ka ho gaya, 30 kilo vajan ghata liya, right? Right Gauri ji?
Yes.
To aap, main ye keh raha hu ki ye jo right na fat hai, aap kyun nahi ghata lete ho? Aap ghata sakte ho, बस आपको चेंज करना है. आप अपनी क्लॉगिंग ऑफ आर्टरी को ना, आप जो स्टेंट लगा रहे हो और आपको डरा दिया गया कि आज नहीं लगाओगे तो चार दिन बाद साफ हो जाओगे, नो, इट्स जस्ट अ फियर फैक्टर. यू कैन टेक दिस ऑफ आल्सो बाय चेंजेस इन द डाइट प्लान. रिमूव दिस प्लेग. व्हाट्स द प्रॉब्लम? व्हाई डोंट यू लर्न दैट नॉट ओनली यू आर रिड्यूसिंग द फैट हियर, but you are also removing the visceral fat and going to get fit and fine. What's there to be scared of? You we need to live a life which is natural with the natural food, instead of sitting and getting it operated for no reasons of yours. High BP, yeah, having said that, I have been also a high BP patient myself. A lot of pressures and things like that. It's all mental, emotional, and of course, so multiple ways it happens. Day for yesterday I was talking to a young engineer around 32 years old. His kidney, he has got a kidney failure. His creatinine levels are almost shooting 5.5 to 6. Last year he gets into a problem with the stomach, gets into it, and then he suddenly finds that his BP was 250/150. He realizes. When did you, how many people are there? I don't know how many people are there. When did you add your last time blood pressure check? Bhai check kar lo. Us bacche ke sath kya hua tha ki usko pata hi nahi chala. Aur kidney kya hai? It's like patli patli pipes hai. Jaise aapke air conditioner jo hota hai na, air conditioner ki jo outdoor unit hoti hai, ya in the patle patle pipe ke, ya car ke radiator ki tarah patli patli channiyan hoti hai, right? यू आर एक्चुअली नो अब इतना प्रेशर है, अगर आप लॉन में पानी दे रहे हो पतला सा पाइप किया तो पानी दूर तक जाता है. आप एथरोस्क्लेरोसिस प्रोसेस जो मैंने दिखा यहाँ करके बैठे हो तो क्या होगा, जो ब्लड ब्लड प्रेशर बढ़ा एंड इट्स गोइंग टू बी ऊजिंग ऑन टू द स्मॉल स्मॉल यू नो वेन्स ऑफ योर किडनीज, और आपके ब्रेन में भी पतली पतली नसें हैं उस पर जब हाई प्रेशर में ब्लड सर्कुलेट होगा क्या होगा, अरे ब्रेन का स्ट्रोक हो जाएगा हाई ब्लड प्रेशर से, आपकी किडनी फेल हो जाएगी. उस बच्चे की किडनी फेल हो चुकी है 32 साल का, अभी तो उसने लाइफ नहीं देखी है. तो हम क्या समझते हैं, आर वी सम सुपरमैन और किंग कॉन्ग? नो. आप बट सवाल है कि ये पतला हुआ क्यों? आपको एक्सरसाइज नहीं करनी है, आपको वॉकिंग नहीं करनी है, आपको जॉगिंग नहीं करनी है, आपको छोले भटूरे खाने हैं, आपको ये खाना है, भाई कब तक? थिंक. ओके, सो आई एम सेइंग ये मेरे पास एक लेडी आती है 90 केजीज की, मेरा बीपी हाई हो गया, मेरे को ये बताओ मैं हल्दी खाऊं कि टमरिक खाऊं कि क्या खाऊं? मैंने कहा रोटी मत खा, छोले भटूरे मत खा, ये मत खा, डू एक्सरसाइज. एक्सरसाइज नहीं होती है बस, और मुझे कोई दवाई दे दो बीपी बढ़ाने की. तो आई से सॉरी मैडम आई कांट डू एनीथिंग फॉर यू. क्यों? अपना ये जो प्लेग अंदर बना के बैठी हुई है कैसे साफ होगा? You have to make changes. You have to walk. You have to do exercise, right? So, of course, there are multiple approaches towards it. There are 10 to 12 different processes and mechanisms so you can take care of BP. We'll not talk about it. This goes out of syllabus at this point of time. So, normal theories, get a BMI, lose weight, have more of potassium, less processed food, have good sleep, garlic, and cut back on coffee. Or coffee mat lijiye please. Omega-3s lijiye, magnesium, coenzyme Q10 lijiye. So, ye sab batate hain. But agar main aapko raaz ki baat bataun, BP aapka kam karna hai na, yo apne jo extra power bank hai na, dekhiye 5000 mAh ka power bank hota hai, 20,000 mAh ka hota hai. Mota kaun hota hai? 20,000 mAh ka hota hai. Ye jo aap battery bank ban ke baithe na, ye aapka jo fat hai na, wo polar bear ki tarah, wo kya hai? You are nothing but your body is like a battery bank. अरे भाई क्यों फैट डाल के रखा है? आप गुफा में थोड़ी ना हो, तो फिर why don't you lose? Think over it. Okay. So of course there's a lot of things. Today I wrote something on the in the group on this alkaline and stuff like that. So basically what happens is here also. Let me see if I can go back. Yeah, so this is high blood pressure. What I'm saying is that there are certain things that you need to do. The best thing that you should do is wohi cheez khaiye jisse kam se kam insulin bane. Kam se kam insulin banega. Iska matlab ye nahi ki you have to starve and get the clogging being cleared. Jab pathway clear ho jayega to aapka blood pressure apne aap hi khatam ho jayega. And aapko you have to just lose weight. That's it. It's not a rocket science. Just think about it. I'll skip over this slide. यूरिक एसिड, कई लोग को एसिडिटी की प्रॉब्लम है. प्रॉब्लम क्या है? ऑफ कोर्स वी आर ईटिंग लॉट ऑफ एसिडिक फूड्स, वी आर ईटिंग प्रोसेस फूड, पैकेट का खाना खाते हैं, रात में सब्जी बनाई अगले दिन सब्जी खा रहे हैं, राइट? वो सुबह उठने का था 7 बजे, उठ के इतने दिन में रहे 11 बजे, रात में 2 बजे. अभी कौओं को देखा है, वो बेचारे शाम को 7 बजे आके पेड़ पे बैठ जाते हैं. अर्ली मॉर्निंग में सनराइज पर वी कॉल इट सर्कैडियन रिदम, राइट? अरे खुद से नहीं सीख सकते, तो अगर बाहर जाके वो पेड़ पे जो डाल पे आपके पक्षी बैठे हैं उनको तो देख के सीखो. Nobody is waking and slogging till 3 o'clock in the morning. They follow the sun, they are healthy. उनको क्या बीपी डायबिटिक कैंसर है क्या? No, we need to change. It's very very important. So all these things, you know, kidney हो रहा है, UTI हो रहा है, तमाम सब चीजें हो रही है. The kind of the foods that we are having, you know, try to you know have the foods which is more of an alkaline. This is good for your UTI, this is good for your gas, this is good for clotting. If Goriji wants, I can send acid and alkaline chart on the group. Maybe this can be circulated. Yeah, or sure. Maybe it can be circulated, so you can very well know looking at the chart which is an acidic food and which is an alkaline food. Mind it simple. Why don't you have to eat an antacid? Why do you have to eat so much medicines and take chemicals? Come on, have simple man. Have a simple alkaline water, alkaline food. All your problem go for a toss. गधे के सर से सींग की तरह गायब होगा खटाक से. Rocket science नहीं है. Health is the simplest thing, provided you do the right things. Simple. The rest is all English. Uric acid बना के बैठे हुए हैं, right? So क्या कर रहे हैं? Green peas, दाल, मशरूम थोड़ा इसमें होता है, and proteins खा रहे हैं. Protein is fine, it's necessary. Protein का मतलब ये नहीं कि आप एकदम सुबह शाम चार चार चम्मच protein का powder लेके सुबह ले लिया और शाम को ले लिया. I'm telling you, you are going to be landing up in lot of problems, right? Because this, you are actually putting up an acid on your body. It's all amino acids. When you are dissolving, you are putting up acid load. उसको कम करने के लिए body will start leaching calcium and magnesium from your bones. आपको पता है ज्यादा protein पीने से हड्डियां कमजोर होती हैं? Did anybody told you? Okay, I'll write an article later on in this group. But just try to, what I'm trying to convey through the slide is have a more of a uric acid. This is something we have, Dhania. I wrote this 4 or 5 years before. I've written this in a group also. So I'll skip over this slide. What I'm trying to convey is here in this slide is have more of an alkaline and blah, blah, blah. Type 3 diabetic ho raha hai. Aajkal ye aa raha hai, wo jo Alzheimer ho raha hai, dementia ho raha hai. To क्या हो रहा है कि ब्रेन है ना, वो जैसे 70,000 किलोमीटर का जो गाड़ी चलता है उसके टायर घिस जाते हैं, वैसे ब्रेन विद पैसेज ऑफ एज घिस जा रहा है. अब क्या होता है, मैंने आपको बताया है कि बॉडी सेल्स जो है या तो ग्लूकोज से एनर्जी ले सकती हैं या फिर कीटोन से एनर्जी ले सकती हैं. कीटोन्स कहाँ से आता है? कीटोन्स फैट से आता है. तो अब आपकी जो दिमाग है ना, वो इंसुलिन रेजिस्टेंस हो चुका है, तो आपका दिमाग ग्लूकोज एब्जॉर्ब नहीं कर पा रहा है. तो जब तुलसी जी का पौधा है, जब उसको पानी नहीं मिलेगा, खाद नहीं मिलेगी, तो तुलसी जी के पत्ते की तरफ मुरझा जाएगा आपका दिमाग, क्योंकि वो दिमाग ही इंसुलिन रेजिस्टेंस हो गया है. अरे भाई, तो कोई बात नहीं, दिमाग इंसुलिन रेजिस्टेंस हो गया तो रहने दो, दूसरा तरीके से तो खाना दे दो. कैसे खाना देंगे दिमाग को? कैसे अपना अल्जाइमर डिमेंशिया दूर करेंगे? वेरी सिंपल, गिव अ गुड फैटी डाइट टू द पर्सन, गुड नेचुरल फैट्स. That's it. You can search on Google or we can take a chart from us. We can tell you exactly as to how do you do. And mind it, aapke shareer mein sabse jyada cholesterol pata hai kahan hai? Aapke dimag mein hai. Aapka dimag 80% cholesterol se bana hua hai. Aur cholesterol koi bahut bada hawa nahi hai. 80% cholesterol bhai aap khud banate ho. Hawa se nahi lete ho. You're not taking it from outside. 80% of the cholesterol your body is producing it. And cholesterol is one of the biggest myth. Har ek log triglycerides kha ke pareshan hai, LDL bad gaya hai, HDL, are bhai bhagwan, hey bhagwan, mera triglycerides bad gaya, ab to main upar chala jaunga, mere ko heart attack ho jayega, ab mera kya hoga? All myths, you need to understand. I'll go back to this. There's a movie which I talked about it. अगर आप फैट्स देते हो, फैट इज द बेस्ट डाइट फॉर योर ब्रेन, गिव गुड फैट. ये जो अल्जाइमर है, ये जो प्रॉब्लम है, ये भूलने के प्रॉब्लम है, सब आपका फैट लॉस भी होगा, आपका दिमाग एकदम पूरा 1000 किलोमीटर एन आर पर दौड़ेगा. सो दैट्स देयर इज अ मूवी व्हिच आई सर्कुलेटेड इन द ग्रुप, मैंने इस पर लिंक भी दिया हुआ है यहाँ पे. किडनी ऑल्सो ऑफकोर्स, इस बच्चे का एग्जाम्पल दिया था, उसका ब्लड प्रेशर की वजह से किडनी फेल हो गई थी. अगेन वही है, आप अपना पाइप क्लियर रखिए. पाइप क्लियर करने के लिए इंसुलिन कंट्रोल कीजिए. ऐसा कोई खाना मत खाइए जिससे बहुत ज्यादा इंसुलिन सेक्रेशन हो जाता है. एंड किडनी में कई लोग बीपी की दवाई खा रहे हैं, वो अपना किडनी का भी उनका जा रहा है, ओटीसी पिल्स, राइट? सो ये सब है. देन यू हैव फूड सप्लीमेंट्स दैट यू कैन गेट. ऑल दीज सप्लीमेंट्स आर बेसिकली लाइक अर्ली फॉर ब्लूबेरीज, रेड, दे एक्चुअली हार्डली सेक्रीट एनी काइंड ऑफ इंसुलिन रिस्पॉन्स हियर. कॉर्टिसोल, आजकल बहुत ज्यादा टेंशन में रहते हैं हम लोग, राइट? तो क्या होता है, टेंशन में क्या होता है, बॉडी को तो पता नहीं ना, बॉडी को दिमाग टेंशन में आ गया तो उसको समझा कि कोई खतरा आ गया. खतरा आ गया तो उसको क्या करना है, इंसुलिन ज्यादा सेक्रीट होना शुरू हो जाता है. क्यों? क्योंकि बॉडी देखती है कि अभी डेंजर है, शायद मेरे पीछे कुत्ता भागने वाला है, कुछ डेंजर है, तो एक्स्ट्रा एनर्जी दो. तो एक्स्ट्रा एनर्जी देने के लिए एक्स्ट्रा ग्लूकोज सेक्रीट होता है, एक्स्ट्रा इंसुलिन सेक्रीट होता है. What happens is insulin reacts with the extra glucose and converts that into fat. So ज्यादा tension करोगे ना भाई तो आपका weight बढ़ जाएगा. इसलिए शांत, अब मैं बोल रहा हूँ, मेरे को खुद tension होती है. That's a separate thing. So, what I'm trying to say is that I just have to be peaceful, and stress releases cortisol hormone, which in turn shoots up your insulin levels and which causes rest of the problems. Sleep is important, we know this. बट प्रॉब्लम ये है कि आज के रात में 11 बजे तक तो मोबाइल पे व्हाट्सएप चलता है और वो सब चलता है. आई डोंट नो. सो वी हैव टू कट डाउन ऑल दिस काइंड ऑफ स्टफ. मेडिटेशन ऑफ कोर्स वी हैव सो मेनी एक्सपर्ट्स फ्रॉम आर्ट ऑफ लिविंग फाउंडेशन. इवन गौरी जी इज एसोसिएटेड विद दैट. सो cleanse your mind, cleanse your body and stuff like that, where you know experts can tell more here. But what I'm saying is that you when you are having a peaceful body, peaceful mind, your hormones signaling, everything gets perfect and you live in a peaceful mind and your enzyme system gets corrected. Stress reduction message, yoga, I'll go. What to eat, of course, very, very simple. I'm making it fast forward now. Don't even go for this. Aata khana, agar meri baat maani hai, toh chhod do. Fayde mein rahoge.
Minutes lo. Birendra ji, kai log sawal pooch rahe hain, jaise kai diabetics hain, jinko jo khapli wheat khate hain, it's called an MR variety of wheat called khapli, which they say is low GI. It's considered to be low GI.
हाँ, वो खा सकते हैं, वो खा सकते हैं. They can have them. Not a problem. But please daily मत खाइए.
What about rice? Is rice equally bad?
Rice is, अगर wheat और rice को रखें तो wheat ज़्यादा बदमाश है, rice भी बदमाश है, मगर कम है. Daily नहीं खाने का, please understand. Get into millets. And diabetes का actually, if the way I help people is basically I work with a combination of a low insulin foods and coupled with the fasting. Actually, fasting is the best way to cure diabetes permanently, and it takes only 90 days. Kuriji, I've told you earlier. So make a note of it. 90 days for you to be diabetic free for the rest of your life. Doesn't matter you are 10-year-old diabetic, 20-year-old diabetic, 30-year-old diabetic. We don't care. Okay. So here, blueberries, avocado, thoda ye foreign ka hai, but jo mile, basically the whole objective is gist of it is aisa kuch khao jisse jyada se jyada insulin secrete na ho. I was being asked to put some one or two slides on superfoods. Moringa apne ghar mein hai. See, here in Greater Noida we have LG, we have Samsung. Lot of South Koreans live. So the dawai ke dukan ke samne they queue up and take this moringa powder. Very, very beneficial. So have this. Talk about it. It's got nutrition, antioxidant, inflammatory, all the 9 essential amino acids. Proteins, more calcium than milk, right? Have it. Nature, superfood, har ek jagah hai. Bhai, kyon nahi lete ho?
So that brings me to the question which many people have all the time is that should we avoid dairy completely?
So I'll tell you, and I think few of you who might have seen this, that I gave example A1 and A2 and stuff. Of course, wahan ka gai ka variety dusra hai, A1 kind of thing, jisme Netherlands is having the largest number of type 1 diabetic in the world, and largest number of Netherlands have a largest per capita consumption of the milk in the world, and having a largest diabetic population in the world is Netherlands. You can Google out what I'm saying. But वहाँ पे A1 होता है, यहाँ पे A2 होता है. Please make a note of it. जो हमारा pancreas का जो structure होता है, और जो milk के protein का structure होता है, basically the body's immune system sometimes get misguided. Make a note of it. Body's immune system gets misguided, and it thinks that there's some pathogen here. So body gets into a hyper inflammatory stage, and your immune system basically considers this as a pathogen. It mounts a very, very strong attack, basically considering the milk protein as a pathogen. When it is mounting the attack, it is not only trying to get rid of those considering that milk is a pathogen, it is also mimicking your pancreatic beta cells. It ruptures your beta cells. Isliye आप देखेंगे type 1 diabetic is an autoimmune disease which happens to the children. People who are diabetic, okay? People who are diabetic, please don't touch or have any milk products. Period. Okay, that gets my answer. तो आप क्या देखते हैं? अरे milk, अरे क्यों ले रहे हो भाई? आपने देखा हाथी का दूध शेर पीता है क्या? या बकरी का दूध गधा पीता है? या गधे का दूध हम पीते हैं? अलग बात है. कैलोपेट्रा हाथी थी, गधे का दूध तो गधे का दूध आइस. हर एक का बेनिफिट होता है. इट्स नॉट सेइंग दैट हर एक चीज खराब है, But here I'm talking if you are in a problem, and if you are in a blood sugar problem, don't have milk. This is one of the alternatives. Look at this, 4 to 6 times. Some people say 10 times, 12 times better, better calcium as compared to milk. See, गाय भी यही लेती है ना, आपको पौधे से ही तो खाती है, चारा खा के ही तो बनाती है. गाय इज नॉट अ फैक्ट्री, राइट? आई एम नॉट अगेंस्ट गाय और अ भैंस और व्हाटएवर. व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू डू इज प्योरली फ्रॉम द एकेडमिक पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. इफ यू आर इनटू अ डायबिटिक कंडीशन, एंड इवन इफ यू आर नॉट इनटू अ डायबिटिक कंडीशन एंड यू हैव टू प्रिवेंट योरसेल्फ, गेट इनटू. आप घी खा सकते हो, मेक अ नोट ऑफ इट. आई एम नॉट अगेंस्ट घी, बिकॉज घी में नो द बैक्टीरिया हैज चेंज्ड द फॉर्म, सो इट्स बेसिकली गुड फैट. आप घी खाइए.
Has enzymes which has living enzymes like A2 Bilona ghee, for example. Yeah. Not all right. ghee, but Bilona ghee specifically has enzymes. Right. So it's very good for your good gut health in general. Yeah, it's very good fat.
Yeah. Correct. So it's good for your health, and sir, because वो है आपका A2 घी है और आपका मक्खन है, कोई problem नहीं है. But दूध as a raw and milk product, please, if it is possible, try to avoid. I will tell this 100 times. Not good. You can go through. I will not go through much of the slide here. Okay, I understand that ये क्विना हमारा local नहीं है, South America में होता है, but अभी यहाँ पे भी लोग उगा रहे हैं. Gauriji, you or people in the group who are more experts than me, they should be knowing. But इसको United Nations ने 2013 में year of quinoa किया था. इसमें सारे micro और macro और micro nutrients आपको अच्छे से मिल जाते हैं. Magnesium है, phosphorus, folate है, copper है. वो हमारे millets में भी रहते हैं. But we have amaranth. There are lot of things that you can do.
I think most of our millets, especially the positive millets, are known to have most of what quinoa has. So there's been some.
Yeah.
Have lot more variety, diversity.
And best part is, audience, please note, best part is quinoa is 100% gluten-free. Yeah. Okay? So if somebody is into a problem of inflammation, kisi ko rheumatoid arthritis hai, kisi ko autoimmune disease hai. Okay? Gauriji, make a note of it.
Yes.
Millets ke kuch millets mein bhi gluten hota hai.
Correct. That's true.
इसमें ग्लूटेन नहीं होता है. सो इफ यू आर इनटू अ मेडिकल कंडीशन, दिस इज अ परफेक्ट ग्लूटेन फ्री, रिच इन द टर्म्स ऑफ प्रोटीन, रिच इन द टर्म्स ऑफ विटामिन, यू कैन पोटेंशियली इमेजिन. सो यू कैन हैव दिस, यू नो. अब महंगा भी नहीं आता है. सो यू नो, न्यूट्रिशियस, टिश्यू ग्रोथ, ब्लड इम्यूनिटी, क्विनोआ इज लिंक्ड विद बेटर हार्ट हेल्थ. इट डज हैव अ स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ कार्ब्स. ओके, it does have a small amount of carbs. It's not 100% carb free, but manageable limit mein hai. So,
buckwheat is gluten free also.
Buckwheat you can have, not a problem. It's helpful in the blood pressure and various other things also. So you can have. So I'll skip it through the slide. Wheat grass dekhiye, maine isme dal diya. Main isko keh raha hu super food hai. Ab morning mein ek wheat grass ka tinch le lo. What is the problem? You alkaline your body, kind of. The benefits you are getting, where it is it coming from? Made in USA? No, it's there right next to your home. Have it. Have aap, chaliye theek hai, quinoa nahi hota, aap bahar se khareed lijiye. Aapka moringa hai, quinoa nahi, ye le lijiye, wheat grass. All these things are there. Okay, I'm coming quickly now. It's too much now. We're already exceeding 20-25 minutes now. So fasting, of course, hame pata hai, it's very very important. Fasting se fayda kya hota hai bhai? सिंपल, अगर आप शुरुआत की स्लाइड समझ गए तो अभी आप स्लाइड समझ सकते हो. फास्टिंग जब करते हैं हम खाना नहीं खाते हैं. जब खाना नहीं खाएंगे तो ग्लूकोज बनेगा नहीं. जब ग्लूकोज आएगा ही नहीं तो इंसुलिन क्या रहेगा? नहीं रहेगा. सो बेसिकली जो हाइपर इंसुलिनेमिया, जो आपने कहा एक सर्किल है, कहीं ना कहीं वो उस लूप में धीरे धीरे आपकी हीलिंग शुरू हो जाएगी. सो दिस लॉट ऑफ बेनिफिट्स विच इज देयर. अच्छा, किसी ने, आई एम श्योर यू माइट हैव सीन, ये जो ये सर्जरी होती है गैस्ट्रिक बाईपास सर्जरी में, इसमें क्या करते हैं? यू नो, आई वाज इन हैदराबाद अर्ली पार्ट ऑफ दिस ईयर, माय सिस्टर्स प्लेस, एंड आई वेंट टू अ हॉस्पिटल. उसमें लिखा था कि ये गैस्ट्रोलॉजी इसका करा लो और डायबिटिक फ्री हो जाओ. गौरीजी, डू यू नो अबाउट दिस? एनीबॉडी नोज अबाउट दिस? दे से दैट यू गेट अ the surgery done and you become a diabetic free.
Really? No, I have.
Yeah. I am sure other hospital, and it was showed. I took a picture. Maybe I'll circulate this in a group later on. So what happens is, simple. Kaise a banda diabetic free? And you know what they were saying? This is a 90% treatment of diabetic. Aap ye kara lo, aur aap diabetic free ho jaoge. 90% success rate. Why? Simple. आपने क्या किया? पेट छोटा कर दिया. पेट छोटा कर दिया तो खाना कम खाएंगे. खाना कम खाएंगे तो क्या आपका होगा? जब खाना कम खाएंगे तो ग्लूकोज कम आएगा ना. जब ग्लूकोज कम आएगा तो सबसे कम फिर वो इंसुलिन भी तो कम आएगा. आपका जो बॉडी है वो इंसुलिन रेजिस्टेंस बन के बैठी हुई थी. प्लीज वॉच माई हैंड. ये इंसुलिन इंसुलिन नाउ स्लोली इंसुलिन. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज द बीटा रिसेप्टर्स इंसुलिन रिसेप्टर जैसे ये है हमारे चारों तरफ सेल्स के दे स्टार्ट हीलिंग एंड इट टेक जस्ट 90 डेज फॉर देम टू हील एंड वंस दे हील व्हाट विल हैपन इज नाउ द ग्लूकोज इज कमिंग द इंसुलिन रिसेप्टर्स आर एक्टिंग प्रॉपरली इट अंडरस्टैंड्स द इंसुलिन सिग्नलिंग द सेल ओपन्स अप एंड अब्सॉर्ब्स ग्लूकोज यू आर अ डायबिटिक फ्री पर्सन नाउ द सेम व्हाई यू गेट इन टू दिस बायरेट्रिक सर्जरी टू रिमूव योर टाइप 2 डायबिटीज Well, eat the kind of food जो कि इंसुलिन कम से कम बनाए और आपकी आपकी डायबिटीज सही हो जाएगी. ये आपको क्यों नहीं बताया था? Think, think कि आप 20 साल से डायबिटीज की दवाई क्यों खा रहे हो? ये होता है फास्टिंग. ये देखिए डाइट है.
Lot of questions being asked about fasting, especially how much of fasting to be done, how it is to be done. So I have my own views on it, but Birendraji, please.
I'll just conclude fast. तो ये देखिए ये टैप देखिए ये डाइट है. ग्लूकोज फ्रुक्टोज भर रहे हैं और ये अगर आपने टोटी नहीं खोली तो ये क्या होगा? You know it better. I'll come out. So my simple funda is have a food which recruits less of the insulin and Giving insulin to the type 2 diabetes is the biggest fraud in this world, which is getting carried right away. I tell to these hospitals, I tell to these doctors. Last time I gave a big shot to this Apollo hospital also. Yeah, when to eat gut bacteria. Okay. Gut bacteria is important. This is a very, very advanced topic. I did my certification and in second certification, I have failed. I did not pass. I am still working on. So it's a very, 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 very important topic that we need to understand that if we compare the number of body cells versus the kind of gut bacteria population that we are living actually inside our digestive tract, they are 10 times more and they contain 100 times more genomic or genomes signaling as compared to normal. In fact, ye itne strong hote hain ki jo hum hamari thought process hai, jo hamara body ki working hai, jo hamara sochna hai, samajhna. In fact, other day I was going through the book, actually, are we a human being or are we a bacteria living in the form of a bacteria living in the form of a human being? Actually, to be frank with you, we are a bacteria living in different shapes and size and colors. We call ourselves a human being, but no, every aspect of it is being, taken care of the gut bacteria. They are the ones responsible for our hormones, signaling, our immunity. And of course, 70% of the immunity is actually being coming from your gut itself. Make a note of it. ये बहुत जरूरी चीज. आप ये किताब में नहीं पढ़ने वाले हो या इस मेरी बात सुनने के बाद यू कैन गूगल इट ऑल्सो इन केस गूगल टेल्स यू करेक्टली. फ्रॉम एवरी सिग्नल विच गोज फ्रॉम ब्रेन टू द गट, वन सिग्नल गोज फ्रॉम द ब्रेन टू गट, देर आर 9 सिग्नल्स विच कम फ्रॉम गट टू ब्रेन, विच मीन्स आवर गट इज 9 टाइम्स मोर कम्युनिकेटिंग विद अवर ब्रेन वर्सेज ब्रेन कम्युनिकेटिंग विद द गट. आवर गट इज सो पावरफुल. So we have this gut microbiome. Jo aap, you have this dahi aap lo, and then you have this Yakult, and then there are probiotic like say, fermented foods, kimchi. There are a lot of stuffs. We have Ritupan who is there in the group. Maybe he is expert in this area. That's not my area of expertise. But what I'm trying to say is mota mota, because we are already over by the time, and I will not explain much on this. That about 70% of the immunity is actually responsible for the gut. The way we think, the way we हम कोई कुछ लोग गुस्सैल ज्यादा होते हैं, कुछ लोग शांत होते हैं, किसी को गुस्सा नहीं आता, कुछ लोग शॉर्ट टेम्पर्ड होते हैं. ये सारा का सारा गट बैक्टीरिया का हिंदी में कहते हैं खेल है, राइट? सो ये इम्पोर्टेंट है, ये अभी भी साइंस का विषय है. दिस लॉट ऑफ रिसर्च इज गेटिंग डन, साइंटिस्ट आर हैविंग न्यू फाइंडिंग. सो दैट्स व्हाई आई से दैट वी आर नॉट अ ह्यूमन बीइंग, वी आर अ बॉडी विच इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय द बैक्टीरिया इनसाइड अस. सो हिप्पोक्रेटिस सेड ऑफ कोर्स ऑल डिजीजेस स्टार्ट इन द गट. ऑफ कोर्स उसके लिए आपको प्रॉपर ऑर्गेनिक फूड खाना पड़ेगा, राइट, और प्रॉपर ग्रीन वेजिटेबल्स वो सब, ताकि बैक्टीरिया का पॉपुलेशन रहे. हम क्या करते हैं, कोक खा लिया, पेप्सी ले लिया, वी ड्रिंक विस्की, लॉट ऑफ विस्की, वी आर किलिंग अवर गट बैक्टीरिया पॉपुलेशन. आपको देखा है ना कि आपने एंटीबायोटिक खाई है, तो मॉर्निंग में आप पैन फोर्टी क्यों खाते हो? थिंक ओवर ऑल द एंटीबायोटिक्स दैट किल योर गट बैक्टीरिया पॉपुलेशन. क्या होता है, चार दिन एंटीबायोटिक खाओ, गट बैक्टीरिया खत्म हो जाते हैं, यू स्टार्ट गेटिंग अ लूज मोशंस. Where are you getting? You are sunflower oil. Is it friendly? No, sorry. Seed oils, antibiotics, acid suppressor, antacids, sugar, artificial sweeteners. What they are doing? They are just killing your gut bacteria. Who are we? We are nothing but our gut bacteria. One line statement. So अभी इसका benefits, this unlimited benefits, it's so much benefit that we even talk couple of days, it'll not finish. I'll just skip over, okay? Lot of things, blood pressure, weight, this thing, gastrointestinal migraines, stress, resistance, things like that.
Okay? One question somebody's asking, is sesame oil bad?
Sesame oil is okay, not that bad, yeah. Okay, so immune system is there. Okay, this is an important slide. Don't you think the slide is looking strange? Yeah, so here, this is, I thought, let me just put, ye corona bahut kuch hai, ye kya ho raha hai corona mein. Simple hai, there are three long strategies that you need to have. One is you need to have a proper vitamin D, you need to have a strong gut, and you need to have an immunomodulator. Now, इन तीनों मंकी का वोल्टेज स्टेबलाइजर से क्या कनेक्शन है, I'm going to be telling you. ये तीन, अभी आप कोरोना को याद रखना तो इन तीन बंदर को याद रखना. I don't know why they make such a big complex medical science. We have, we have Ritu in this group, or we have Nikhil in the group, you know. They have been working a lot on this, especially Nikhil, Ritu on the gut bacteria side. But what I'm trying to say is that these three things are important. Let me go back to it, okay?
Ritu is so, very much here. You want him to talk?
We can maybe once we have the question answer session. I'm just remembering my friends here, and then we have I extended invite to Nikhil also. He's done a fantastic jobs all across India, you know, and fixing people. So one is that D3 aapka level jo hai wo apna rakhiye proper. It is confirmed right now. Ye jo maine abhi jo article ka screenshot diya hai, ye 3rd of September ka hai. Hyperlink maine diya hua hai. It's confirmed in the medical community also that D3 is very, very important. Vitamin D is very, very important. Ensure that your typical, abhi kya 99% of us are vitamin D deficient, aap immediately lena shuru kar de. And your target range, topically, ek normal way mein, aapka 30-35 normal range hota hai. But what you need to actually look into is, 75 to 80 nanomole per liter. Is the kind of thing that you need to do. So there's a dosage that you need to do, and it will show that this is the kind of the concentration that you need to have in your blood. Okay, so what this would do is, if you are get, will it prevent me a COVID infection? No, it will not. But what it will happen is, agar aapko hua to aapki sthiti bigdegi nahi. Whether you are a diabetic patient, whether you are a kidney patient, whether you are a BP patient, or you are a normal person, ensure that you take a slightly elevated dose of vitamin D3. Of course, take it along with the K2-7 for a better absorption. So this is one line of defense. I have written that you need to have 75 to 80 nanomole liter kind of concentration in your blood. You can get your blood being tested, find out your vitamin D concentration and start having it. I've also given up the dose, that fivefold the normal dose, 20,000 IUs a day for 2 weeks you can have. Or you know, you can have a normal prophylaxis dose of like 5,000 kind of IU on a per day basis, or even you can have 10,000. till you get the requisite concentration in your blood. Okay, I'm telling you, law of mathematics will kill. We are already the highest in the world right now for last 15 days. Yesterday it was there in Times of India. Ensure in the slide that, you know, you have a proper vitamin D concentration. It is not in slide. This is proven right now. Okay, immune system, I have to. One thing, of course, we are not talking about immunology. I'm not talking about corona. But if you are into metabolic syndrome, which means if you are in a diabetic BP, or if you are obese, means you are overweight, your BMI kind of thing is, when we say obese is like 30 plus with a bulging stomach, make a note of it, your body has a elevated receptors for corona. We call it as AC2 receptors. So what happens is, those wo corona dekha hai, gend ki tarah, charo taraf usme jo kaante nikle hain, that kaante is nothing but a spike protein. So what corona does, that spike protein latches onto the AC2 receptors. Okay, so that's why the deaths which has actually happened, or people getting infected right now, 70-80% of the deaths are happened only for people who were already into some kind of existing metabolic syndrome. Remember in the beginning of slide, I told you that 75% duniya mein jo problems hai, this is all relating with metabolism. It is not relating with corona, it is relating with corona. Aur corona bhi 80% unhi log ko asar kiya hai jiske paas existing metabolic problem hai. And then we have things like this, I put up immunomodulators, like we have a lot of things like Nigella, then we have curcumin, berberine, we have this giloy, we have this tulsi, but of course curcumin and berberine is the one which is like slightly does better as compared to Nigella or various other options. So these are things, these are from the nature. Isi ki tarike se, what will happen is, corona is not causing the death. It is your, make a note of it, your hyperactive immune system which gets triggered is the one which is causing death. And that particular thing that we call is a cytokine. So an infection comes, we have a strong antibody response which is actually happening. So here what happens is, too much of the cytokines are produced in order to counteract and nullify this virus. So our body gets into something like a cytokine storm. So it is very, very important. Wo aandhi aati hai cytokines proteins ki. So us aandhi ko modulate karna hota hai. Taki, it's just very, very simple. If my air conditioner is working on 220 volt, and if I don't have a stabilizer, to 10,000 volt ka current aayega, to mera stabilizer, TV, sab kuch jal jayega. Right? Similarly, in a COVID, what is happening is, this is actually inducing itna jada andar se multiply karna shuru ho jata hai. The immune system also gets into a hyper-inflammatory response, and it produces millions and millions of cytokines proteins. We, medical terms, we call it cytokine storm. And it's the cytokine storms which actually induces death for you. Corona is just an activator for this. So your immune system, that is why we are giving medicines or the steroids for anti-inflammatory medications we are giving, or people who are into rheumatoid arthritis, right? So what is rheumatoid arthritis? It's a immune problem. So we are giving a rheumatoid arthritis medicines to the corona patients. Why? Simple. We want to prevent a strong anti-immune response. Right? So ye bandar hai na, to ye stabilizer. What is this stabilizer? A stabilizer is your curcumin, berberine, nagela, and giloy, and various other things that you can have. Get the best one. Aajkal bahut ye Amazon vagera pe aur Flipkart aur wo sab get there, or Goriji can help. These are all you can get it from a genuine source. It's fine. Otherwise, you are into a problem. Nakli cheez khake.
We have many sources.
So get it done. This is a stabilizer basically. So agar teen bandaron ki baat kare to ek bandar vitamin D, dusra wala strong gut ka hai, teesra wala immunomodulator. Agar aapne ye kar liya, aapka voltage stabilizer theek hai, aata hai, aane do, koi tension nahi. निकल आएगा, निकल जाएगा, आपको पता नहीं चलेगा. दिस इज द सिंपलेस्ट कोरोना एक्सप्लेनेशन, राइट? थोड़ा सा आई हैड टू गिव अ स्लाइड, ये पुराना स्लाइड है, मगर आप देखिए कि डेथ रेट जो होती है, ऑफ कोर्स व्हेन वी ग्रो grow higher in the age, of course, your body metabolism grows down. And that's where, you know, we have a lot of issues and death reported. इसीलिए government ने नियम बनाया कि 60 साल के ऊपर के लोग नहीं चाहें. But if you look at it, cardiovascular disease है, diabetes है, किसी को सांस की problem है, hypertension है, तो उनकी deaths ज्यादा हुई है. और males are having greater number of deaths because of compared to the female because of the difference in the genetic structure that is XX versus XY chromosome. I think I have written that also in the group, right? And these are all something which I am not saying. This is all these are research links or research reports and things like that. So 80% of the deaths are people with the existing metabolic system. So if I have to summarize here, this is the last slide. Thanks for bearing with me. I have put this slide earlier also. Obesity, and this is insulin resistance. What is actually causing you insulin? Please understand, insulin is resistance is not about the diabetes. No, you are having too much of it, you have a heart attack, you have a diabetes, you have Alzheimer, dementia, Parkinson's, you have mood disorder. Ladies, PCOS, PCOD, not getting pregnant, irregular cycles, right? And you are, please, I'm sorry to say, you guys are going to gynecologist and you have your medicines in the home. You come and have 3 pieces of aloo paratha. What is this? Will the medicines help? Will it remove all your problems? Who is screwing up the hormone system? You with your food, nobody else. It's just a bypass. Medicines is not a solution. Please understand, that's the whole objective which is there. Okay. Abhi dekhiye, carbs hai, and then you have proteins, fat, and fasting. Fasting is, of course, the best thing. Isiliye purane zamane mein, abhi to aaj ke zamane ki modern aurte fasting bhi nahi karti. Yani to hamare mother or grandmother, un sab mein to we used to have a regular fasting. I don't know. Some of you might be doing it.
I think it's all coming back now, and I think Ekadashi fasting is getting very popular, something which is done once in 15 days. Also
my last slide of the day, obesity hai, aap metabolic syndrome mein jaate hain, aapko kya kya hota hai, upar se diagram dekhiye na, heart attack hota hai, stroke hota hai, kidney hota hai, blindness hota hai. Are bhai, mera ye kehna hai ki what is more important, your BMWs, Audis, aapke bangle, aapka wo, ya aapka 55 इंच का अल्ट्रा एचडी टेलीविजन विद 200 एमबीपीएस जियो फाइबर कनेक्शन, आपको क्या चाहिए लाइफ में? डू यू वांट दिस? कैन मनी बाय योर लाइफ? इफ दैट वाज द केस, देन यू नो द स्टीव जॉब्स, द फाउंडर ऑफ एप्पल, यू नो ही डाइज विद अ पैनक्रेटिक कैंसर, व्हाट्स द मनी प्रॉब्लम विद देम? आई हैव रियलाइज्ड द मेडिकल प्रॉब्लम्स माईसेल्फ, राइट? मैं एक भुक्तभोगी हूं. आई डोंट वांट पीपल टू सफर, राइट? आप Are you so lame? Are you so weak? आप अपनी पूरी जिंदगी दवाई खाने पर देना चाहते हो? क्यों? Why don't you improve? Why don't you fix yourself? Why don't you understand this? Please don't take shortcuts in the life, right? Dreaming and becoming like an Ayesha Raya by lying in the bed having aloo parathas and chola bhatura would not help you. Both the males and the females, your hard work is the one which will pave you off. Thank you very much.
Thank you. That's wonderful, Birendra. My God, there's so much to learn and so much more which you wanted to delve in. I know there are lots of questions. So, Birendra, my request is next 5 minutes, let's honor all the participants who've been asking lots of things in the chat box. But there are some specifically who want to ask questions. So, I'll be happy to unmute them if they put their hand up and want to ask any specific questions. I heard Shubhra wanted to. So Shubhra, you all can of course give your feedback, while people are asking, getting ready to ask questions. Go ahead and share your feedbacks. Share feedbacks on my number 9818290090. So we have them as testimonials also. It'll be wonderful if you can WhatsApp. Those who want to join us on our WhatsApp groups, you're most welcome to do it. I think most of you already are, but there may be a few who may not be. Yes, it was an info-packed session, no doubt. And, Birendra is brimming with information. So this whole session could have been organized in 10 different ways. And what I found so interesting about Birendra when he came on our platform, he's in a couple of our groups, not all of them. What I found very interesting is that he had a way of engaging people. So he was probably not able to do it because of paucity of time here, but he has this wonderful way of asking questions, you know, breaking people's doubts, making them think about it, getting them to, reflect on the root cause. And that is really what I found outstanding about Birendra, because many of these things are available. I mean, it's not that this information is not available on the net, but there is nobody who kind of explains it to you in the way a lay person wants to understand it. And I think the message in, which he's driven home, actually, if you ask me, somebody asked me that what was this one takeaway in this whole thing? Actually, instead of my saying that, what we will do, Birendra, if you don't mind, one very quick exercise we want to do in the chat box and just take exactly 30 seconds for it is share two of your takeaways, one or two of your takeaways from the session, because that is really what you're going to, you spend good 1.5 plus hours here. And I think it's very important for you to take something back with you, which is reinforced. So can we, I'm seeing people raise their hands. We will take them, but let's first write down just one or two takeaways from the entire session. Cut on carbs, right? Fasting is good.
May I ask a question, please?
No, you can, but Param, after a moment, let's just finish this exercise. Then you can. Yeah. Less carbs, gut is everything. Natural foods, fasting, no carbs, fasting. Identifying good foods, even fruits. Okay, good. Fat is good. Great. Reduce.
Fat is your friend.
Eat more greens. Yeah. Avoid insulin spikes. So you are getting the message. I think, all these things in many ways, they keep coming to us through media. But if I saw that he was able to drive this right through, that if there is one thing you need to look at is your insulin resistance, you fix that bit. And then you're able to see a lot of these autoimmune disorders and metabolic disorders being taken care of. So I think that's a wonderful message to have left behind instead of 100 messages which people try to give. So that's fantastic. Now there are many questions coming in. Param, go ahead. You can ask yours now. You can unmute yourself. I think you were, please go ahead.
You've given an excellent.
You again muted, Param. Can you just fix your audio? We can't hear you, Param.
Okay. Just a minute.
We got you now.
You're again muted. Actually, there's a lag between the processor cycle and the front end processing.
Yeah. No, Param, we have again lost you. I suggest you put it on chat box. We can't hear you. Okay. Shubhra, you want a question? You have a question?
No, I'm just good. Thank you for a wonderful session. Enough to work on for now. Thank you.
Great. I have lost 20 kgs. Dipti is sharing that on Birendraji's advice, she has lost 20 kgs in last 5 months.
Yeah. Dipti is one live example. I am the one who asked her to cut not eating this dasheri mangoes.
Okay. So, it was very amazing. He was sharing the story with me. Dipti, do you want to very quickly in about half a minute?
Yeah, she lost 18 kgs. Can you just share, Dipti, what you did?
Please quickly. Unmute yourself and share. Dipti? Okay. So, no, I'm not going to share.
Can you hear me all?
Yeah, Dipti, we can hear you. Okay. Tell me what you did to lose your...
Birendra, you'll be happy to know now I've lost 20 kgs.
Excellent.
I am on the same food diet which you have advised, and I want to continue it for my lifetime. That is what it is.
So what is the diet? Can you share with the very quickly? People would want to know about it.
Thing which Birendra has told us today, almost no carbohydrates and lot of green vegetables, no milk. And I take dahi though.
दूध बंद करवाया
मैंने बचपन से पिया, पर इन्होंने बहुत मुझे समझाया, and finally I stopped drinking milk and fasting. I fast the two Ekadashis and Puranmasis. That's what I do.
I wanted to hear, intervene and share, because when a lot of questions are coming up on fasting, and I know Biren is on the same aligned on this point. That our Indian Ayurvedic system, or you may call it Ayurvedic or our ancient system, whichever way you want to call it, because some of it is traditional, is very, very scientific. And frankly, there is something which we don't need to fix our intermittent fasting, how many hours, etc. If you look at the Ayurvedic system, it tells you to eat before the sun is down. Okay. So even if you can't do it before the sun is down, before seven, if you can have your last meal, if at all you want to have your last meal, because two meals in a day are really good. I think Birendraji mentioned that too. Now, if you want your last meal, make it before 7 o'clock, and you have your next meal by next at 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock next morning, and you are done with your intermittent fasting. You don't need to do anything else. And then you do your Ekadashi Vrats or any other Vrats. You have do two detoxes in a year, which is your 2 9-day Navratris in a year where you actually take no grains. I think you're going to do fine if you're able to manage the system. I hope all of you will agree with me on that. Right? Great. Any other questions? Any questions for Birendra ji? Because I've just extended the time so that you all can ask your questions. Yeah, fasting becomes difficult for people who have a tendency towards migraines and acidity. My suggestion personally is, Birendra, if you want to answer.
Do a fat fasting.
Super, yeah.
Fat fasting means you have the fats. देखिए ना रहेगा बांस ना बजेगी बसुरी फैट लोगे इंसुलिन सेक्रेट नहीं होगा इंसुलिन ही आपको मोटा बनाता है जब इंसुलिन ही नहीं रहेगा आप मोटे कैसे बनोगे
एंड वेरी गुड पॉइंट बीरेंद्र जी आल्सो फॉर पित्ता कफा एंड वाता दोज ऑफ यू हु अंडरस्टैंड आयुर्वेदा द रूल्स फॉर फास्टिंग आर अ लिटिल डिफरेंट सो प्लीज यू नो रीड अबाउट इट वी विल आल्सो ट्राई टू शेयर दैट विद यू लेटर
Okay. Yeah, sure. We can have a better experts. That's not my.
Param, you can question now.
Yeah. Any other question? Param, you want to still ask? Go ahead.
Yes, madam. I must compliment Dr. Birendra for his.
I'm not doctor.
That's the whole point.
Okay, it's fine. You may not be a doctor, but you have given us a very good talk. I'm a doctor, and. What fascinates me was, I'm on keto diet. That is basically high protein, high fat, no carbohydrate diet, and I've lost 12 kgs in 4 months. I'm very happy with that diet. All I eat is chicken and eggs and all, and I'm very happy about losing this sort of a weight. What are your comments on that?
I have a question about high protein here, Birendra ji. I think we discussed this earlier. Can you just share a bit on that?
Yeah. Reduce the protein a bit. Have more of a good natural fats. If you have too much of protein, you will break your bones. Protein lene se haddiya kamzor ho jati hain and you will add up into a lot of issues. So reduce protein a bit. See, if I have to do, the fat has to be here, protein has to be here, and carbs has to be like nothing. Only thing is that no sir you have a good amount of good fats that's not a problem protein ka ek certain level you know what is the normal protein levels that we require in a normal body
the whole point and there is research around that what we really require now
Yeah, maybe I'll do a posting on protein, maybe in 1 or 2 days. You will be shocked.
We'll talk about that. You need to understand how much we require. Vaishali, yes, please. You can unmute yourself. Just make the questions very quick, okay?
Quickly, please. May I request if my wife is Hi. Listening, can you yes. bring a charger? Hi. My laptop is about to die. Yeah, go ahead and ask.
I wanted to ask a quick question. So me and my mom both are on this diet, exactly what you suggested. We are trying to be 75 to 80% on raw vegetables and fruits. Very limited amount of carbohydrates, mostly coming in from quinoa and buckwheat and other pseudo grains. And intermittent fasting has become our everyday thing. But in spite of all these things, my mom's inflammation markers are still on the high, though she has really improved. On many other aspects, but her inflammation marker is still on high. By inflammation marker, I mean only ESR, which is high. So I wanted to know, yes, she has cut off fats from her body completely. Like there is no source of fat. So which I, from today's this thing, I've learned that fats should be incorporated. And can you please suggest what are the best and most easy to digest kinds of fats like what for a vegetarian vegan diet so what would be the best And also one more question, right. Both of us have lost a lot of weight. My mother has gone from 55 to 43 and I have gone from 43 to 37 or 38. So we're looking really, really like, you know, really like looking gaunt. So if there is any way we could also put on a little muscle mass or anything, because of she being on an alkalining diet, she's also not consuming too much of proteins. She's on a very low protein diet too.
She's on low protein and low fat also. You know what my suggestion, Birendra, if you don't mind, I'll interrupt here. What we will do is, what we were planning to do after this session also, we felt that some people really need support in their diet plans, okay?
They genuinely, we can work it out, case to case basis.
We can work out, we can customize some diet plans for y'all. Let's do that instead of trying to solve individual problems here. I think it's not fair because we have limited time and there are too many questions.
Yeah, so let me
customize this for you, okay?
Yeah. Correct. So let me give a quick answer. Fats doesn't cause inflammation. Period. That's a myth. Yeah.
Sameer, can you please share your question quickly and unmute yourself?
Yeah. Hi. Thanks, Gauri. But as you suggested, my question is also a bit broad. I'm totally confused with this gut problem that I have, whether it's a gut, whether it's acidity and all. But the symptoms are there, like the headaches and the chest aches and the chest burns. So I'm just a bit clueless as to be. I have visited at least a dozen full of doctors and all variety, allopathy, Ayurveda, homeopathy. And it's more than 1 year now that I'm struggling with this headaches and chest aches and all, acids, gases, sore liquid in your throats coming up and all and all and all. So I believe that it is a gut problem.
Yes, you are correct.
I believe that I should go on an alkaline diet. I am actually trying to do that. But somehow maybe my still diet is not perfect. I'm still not hitting that milestone.
Yeah, so we can take this as a gut-to-gut basis because this is not a general problem. As you suspected, this is a gut problem and there are some multiple, other issues, signaling-related issues. We have a very, very complex signaling mechanisms in the body. So this needs to be looked into the case-to-case basis. And of course, your thing can be fixed. It's not a big deal. There's some marker, there's some issue which would have been missed by the doctors and things. So we can have a look at it.
No? Birendra, I also wanted to add here, because since this focus of this session was more around nutrition, I wanted to add here a very, very important part of shifting our lifestyle is about stress. Okay. A lot of diseases are psychosomatic also. They affect our guts. They affect everything which we are going through. So one very important thing to really take care of is the stress level. So we'll maybe some other time we'll take this up. But you can't just fix your body without fixing this part. That's very important to understand.
That's correct. That's correct.
Okay. Anybody else? Karishma, thank you have a question? Yeah. Karishma, please. Yeah, Malini, I can see your hand, but let me just...
Actually, I have two questions. One is regarding, I am always low on hemoglobin, despite the fact that I have taken so many supplements with vitamin C and fruit juices to get absorption. I cook the food in the iron kadai, still that doesn't help. My hemoglobin has been perpetually low. That is one issue I'm not able to fix. And second thing is, in the slides, whatever food you mentioned that one should avoid for uric acid, my husband doesn't take any of those food. And he takes a raw food every time in the dinner, but he's still suffering with uric acid issues now and then. So these are the two things I needed a little bit clarity and solution on.
You will share your reports, maybe the last couple of reports, but I'm sure there's something which is mixed out. I tell you, we have a live example of Deepthi. She was trying to have a weight loss. She was doing everything fine. I'm sure she might be listening also. But only mistake she was doing was the following. As I told you, she was having fruit. She's fond of mangoes. That's one. I caught hold of it. The second one I got hold of the Deepthi's issue was she is having a cow of her own. Feeds the cow with the organic food. Of course, there are various other changes done by her. But what we got hold of is that although the insulin, the milk glycemic index is somewhere 17, 18, but insulin index of milk is somewhere going into the 80s range. So which means that you are triggering the insulin hormone. And since the insulin hormone remains elevated, the weight loss will never happen. So as simple as cutting up milk and slight changes on the fructose resulted in the weight loss. So here, there's some element what I'm trying to correlate with one particular example, which you have spoken already in this forum, is something that we can look forward. There's no general treatment because you're coming at the specific. Right now, this is a general workshop. So I'll just stress on this, but maybe you can discuss this with Gauri and offline we can take this up. But yes, it can be fixed. There's nothing, make a note of it. There's nothing in this world which cannot be fixed. If a person like me with the 19 surgeries on the body can walk 10 kilometers a day and jump in sea and drive on the toughest terrains in Himachal Pradesh, anybody can fix themselves. That's what I say.
Wonderful. Birendra, a question. I think a couple of people are asking this, that you were talking about good fats and I interrupted you.
Right.
Can you explore a bit on that?
So when we see, and if you are a vegetarian, then it's a tough choice. Even I am a vegetarian, so it's a really tough. But what we can have is we have things like, coconuts is there, right? And then we have all your dry fruits like seeds, chia seeds, almonds, walnuts, right? Although berries are not fat, but then they are less of this thing. Then you have a coconut. Coconut is there. You can have coconut flour. So choices of fats is limited. Then of course, when I write avocado is something main ek do bar laya tha, khud khaya, pasand nahi aaya, phek diya. Aur 100 rupaye ka aata hai. So we say it local, but that's again a good amount of fat which is there. Oils maybe aap cook kare to, have mustard oil and other stuff. But fat choices are limited. So it's not that easy, having a good fats. Coconut to hai. और भी choices limited हैं
इसमें somebody was asking कि अगर हम लोग vegan नहीं हैं जो लोग vegan हैं तो उनके लिए तो और भी मुश्किल है
नहीं उनके लिए बहुत easy है actually बहुत easy है आप मतलब we try to avoid the red meat kind of stuff otherwise, what you are eating in the meat is nothing but is a fat so when you are actually you are non-veg and you are having a fat your insulin production is the least Since there is no insulin production, you lose the fast. Because what happens is when you are eating a carb breaks into the glucose. When you're eating the fat, it's basically metabolized into ketones, right? And so for non-vegetarians, the weight loss is the easiest method to do. In fact, your LDL, your HDL, and various other markers are actually drastically improved within 2 to 3 months of correct diet. And not only this, make a note of it. Have anybody heard of reverse aging? Okay. If you have not heard about reverse aging, aap apni ayu wapas ja sakte hain 20-25 saal pehle. Wow, everything comes from the brain. What is brain? Brain is fat. The highest fatty organ in our body is brain. And brain loves fat. Okay. So if you are having too much of fat, you are feeding your brain with the ketones, your brain starts improving and your pituitary gland, your master hormonal signaling gets into a corrective mode. What we are nothing but we are a chemical factory. Okay. So for non-veg, it's pretty easy.
Our question was not about non-veg. The question was about vegetarians who also have, dairy, right? We are saying if milk is not okay, does it also mean that curd and chaach and ghee is not
curd le sakte hain, chaach le sakte hain. Ab main raw milk ke khilaf hu. Aap curd le lo, acha hai. Lactobacillus bacteria hai. It's good for your gut. Aur aajkal to aapko zarur lena chahiye. Because I told you in the slide 70%. Aap milk lijiye, aap makhan lijiye, aap ghee khub khaiye, acha wala. आप बाकी अपना ड्राई फ्रूट्स लीजिए आप डेली नारियल पानी पीजिए आप मिलेट्स की एक रोटी खाएंगे बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स रिच इन सो मच फाइबर कि आपका एक ही रोटी से आपका पेट भर जाएगा वो आप लीजिए तो आप फिक्स आप सिर्फ अपना डायबिटीज नहीं मैं डायबिटीज की नहीं बात करूं आप अपना कैंसर फिक्स करो आप अपना वेट फिक्स करो आप अपना जो डॉक्टर कह रहे हैं ना कि आपकी कार्डियो की सर्जरी है वो प्लीज मेक अ नोट ऑफ इट व्हेन आई एम टॉकिंग वी हैव फिक्स्ड पीपल No, nothing more than better than my own mother. She was diagnosed with the cancer, right?
Super. Malini, you have a question?
Shall we end now? We are already like one hour.
Maybe we can take one or two more questions, Birendra, if you don't mind.
Yeah, sure.
People are
hi, can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you. Yeah,
thank you very much for that information packed session. Thank you, Ningari and Mirindaji. I have one question. There is a lot of probably myths about protein that, you know, you need to consume probably 10% of your body weight as a regular, you know, as your daily protein intake and things like that. I'm getting totally confused, especially as a vegetarian. Can you just clear the air here, please?
Yeah, I think normal, yeah, there is some equation which is there for the protein, but you don't require really 60, not more than 60 to 80 grams of protein. More than that is not a, you know, it's going to be a problem because it is basically gets converted into acid. I'll tell you how it happens. Aap jyada protein longe, you are going to be creating a lot of acid content in the body, okay? Aur protein lene se haddiya kaise kamzor hoti, let me also tell you. So body has to maintain a neutral pH, okay? Somebody had written like 7.4 kind of stuff. Body wants to have you know, a kind of neutral, near to neutral pH. When you're putting too much acid by the terms of consuming too much of protein, what will happen is that body trying to neutralize that extra acid that you have taken in your body by consuming extra protein. So then body has to get something which is alkaline. So body kya karega? Aapki jo haddi hoti, haddi is calcium, okay? Calcium, magnesium. वो आपका हड्डी बॉडी क्या करेगा, आपकी हड्डी से कैल्शियम और मैग्नीशियम लेगा टू मेक द पीएच ऑफ द बॉडी न्यूट्रल बिकॉज यू हैव पुट टू मच ऑफ प्रोटीन इनसाइड इट. सो व्हाट विल हैपन, इट स्टार्ट लीचिंग आउट योर कैल्शियम मैग्नीशियम. सो टू मच ऑफ द प्रोटीन विल इंश्योर दैट योर बोन्स बिकम वीक. उल्टा लगता है बट दिस इज द ट्रूथ, नोबडी टेल्स यू. डोंट गो फॉर एक्स्ट्रा प्रोटीन्स, डजंट हेल्प यू.
Okay, so all of you who want to reach out for any diet plans or advice, as I said, you have my number with you. Please reach out there. We will form a group. Those who have customized needs, we will ensure that they are met with. Okay, so don't worry about that. Now coming to, is there anybody who has a very urgent, important and unmissable question which cannot be asked later also? Only that person, please. Come on the chat box and tell us. This is the last question we are going to ask. Only somebody who thinks that they need to ask right now, it's something which is imperative. Because there are 5-6 hands up, I will only give a chance to the person who genuinely believes that they need very badly to ask the question. Okay, so I don't see anybody on the chat box saying that. So we are going to close the session now. There's a fibroids question and there's a hypothyroid question. I think these can be handled later, Virendra. What do you say?
Yeah, we can have a specialist session. I can have the concerned specialist also, yeah. where this can be handled. This is more of a, you know, general question. Yeah. So if I have to summarize, 75% of the problem is all because of issues relating with metabolism. As Goriji said, it's not corona, it's the metabolic problem. Who created it? You created it. Who can fix it? You can fix it. You want to give your life to pills? Choice is yours. After all, life is yours. Thank you.
Fantastic. Wonderful, Birendra. I feel that all of you after this session need to put down 2 or 3 takeaways and your own implementation plan. We are making a group together. I think most people are already in that group. There are few who may not be in the group. You have my number. Come and join that group. Make your plan and share that plan on the group so that you know that you are committed to it. Those who had very specific customized needs, reach out to me on my number and inbox, and we'll be happy to do that. The third thing I wanted to share is that we also have, because we have the largest network of organic and diverse foods across India, we will try those of you who want to shift your diets into chemical free, or you want some very specific kind of foods to add to your diet, which is going to be helpful. We'll be very happy to support you. In this way, we are only supporting the farmers. Sorry, this is not my business. It is to make sure that the farmers grow something biodiverse, which meets your nutrient needs, right? So go ahead and do that. And thank you very much for being this wonderful audience and engaging. We want more and more of Birendras to come and educate us, because we really feel that, getting this kind of, it's not information, it is knowledge. Because then you start really relating to what is happening to you and it makes you ready to take action. Anything which is information never makes you ready to take action. What is knowledge makes you ready to take action. So today what we had was a knowledge session and knowledge.